Broadcasting live from the Wolfe Radio Studios, it's time for the John Clay Wolfe Show. From coast to coast, the number one weekend morning show in America. Heard in Miami, Washington, D.C., Houston, Dallas, Nashville, Pittsburgh, Charlotte, Orlando, Cincinnati, New Orleans, Oklahoma City, Austin, and broadcasting to the rest of the world at johnclaywolfe.com. Hit him up now, 800-800-RADIO. 800-800-RADIO. Now, John Clay Wolfe.
Speaking of aliens, illegal aliens.
Yes.
Not from outer space. Just okay. From other borders. Not extraterrestrials like Gigi. But,
you mean undocumented workers. That's what you mean.
I think this guy might be a documented worker, but Lionel Messi is leaving Argentina and coming to Miami.
Oh, yeah. Soccer player.
Biggest soccer player ever. I mean, it's like Tom Brady. Who's bigger than Tom Brady? It's Michael Jordan of soccer.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So how can he work over here? Does he have to pay Argentina tax and Miami tax and U.S. tax?
Right.
I mean, my father-in-law from Denmark wants to come over here, and they won't let him.
They won't let him?
I mean, he hadn't really tried.
No.
But it's looked like a bunch of pain in the ass.
Huh.
My kid's grandfather.
Does he really want to be over here?
But just let this rich Argentinian soccer player come over here. No problem.
How about that?
We were here first.
Uh-oh.
It's money, John. Money.
Messi. Turley, do you know anything about soccer?
I mean, very little, but yeah.
I mean, you know, white, black, checkered ball.
Yeah. Enough to
hot Brazilian chicks. Yeah. Pablo Escobar. Cocaine. Guns.
There's a lot of money in soccer.
Dark-skinned chicks.
He's also going to get a part of a franchise, too, part of the deal.
We're going to give you a team?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Wow.
That's what they did with Beckham to get
That's
him
what they
here.
Did with Beckham to get him
yeah.
to L.A.
Yeah.
But that didn't really... But Beckham's... Did Beckham coming over to the Galaxy help soccer?
Yeah.
In U.S.?
Yeah, it did.
Okay.
Yeah. It's not a fourth, if you can rank the sports.
Okay.
It's not up there in the top
What's the
four.
First sport?
Well, football.
Oh, football, yeah, of course. Yeah, man sport.
Yeah.
And then what's the second sport?
Baseball.
Basketball.
Yeah, it varies. I think right now basketball is, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Basketball, then baseball, then hockey. And then you're going, that's where your fringe sports are.
Fringe? Not French?
No, fringe,
okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Soccer. Is it
ice
better
skating,
than,
curling. Yeah.
Is it better than pickleball?
Pickleball's better than soccer.
Man, you're gonna get.
It is growing fast.
It is.
I mean, the Mexicans don't like it.
Tennis better than soccer?
No.
Golf.
Golf's better than pickleball and better than soccer.
So that's five.
Well, see, this is racial. You know, John, you have to turn everything into race.
Well,
have you ever driven up to a big soccer game? It's 97.4% Mexican.
It's very Hispanic. Yes. Yes.
It's a big fan base.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
It's a big dominant fan base in the sport of soccer.
Absolutely.
But, you know, if you're in Europe, I mean, it's the same thing with Italians and the English, and some people love their soccer. Love their soccer.
Gigi, why don't black people play golf as much as they should?
I don't know. Maybe because they wouldn't let them on the golf course a long time ago, and some people still have trouble today.
But they'll let them on the soccer course.
I'll take what is discrimination for 200, please.
Uh-huh. He's not a hater. He's a Texan.
Well.
He's the accidental racist.
That's her, not me.
What?
You
How,
just
why
asked
I have to be the racist?
Question.
I just asked a question. I didn't do anything wrong.
Okay.
Other fringe sports, swimming.
Swimming.
Is that better than soccer?
But like what? You know, the soccer is a larger sport around the world than football, than anything.
Yeah,
it's ridiculous.
It is.
The value of club. What's it in England?
What, Barcelona?
No, it's the other one. I forget. But yeah, it's a bigger deal than any football team we have.
Oh, they're worth billions.
Why in the hell has that passion not spilled over to the United States? When it's that way around the world. The World Cup is the largest sporting event in the world. Is it larger than the Olympics? I don't know. Could be.
Yeah. Well, you get more events for your buck because they don't wait 4 years, you know.
Right. And what does large mean? But is the World Cup more watched than the Olympics? No. But
I think it is.
Really?
Yeah.
Why is it not spilled over here? Gigi?
maybe it's just not exciting. I mean, I was in Germany when they had the World Cup in 2018, and they have big, like, statues of soccer players in parks and things like that. So maybe it's just not, it's very boring to watch people kick a ball down a field.
It's not boring for the rest of the world. 800-800.
I know. So maybe we need some more, I don't know, we need to have some fights on the field or something to make it interesting for us.
They're hellacious actors.
Oh my God, they are.
They're wonderful actors.
Yeah.
It's so fun to watch them dive.
The American professional sports, though, have been fine-tuned over a century in some cases. There's more scoring, and it's incremental. First down, second down, third down. Soccer's kind of like hockey. You just say, go, 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 score! And wait 40 minutes. Go, 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 score! Mm-hmm. And it just doesn't appeal to the American sensibility.
Dude, if we were good...
I like hockey, but I can't watch it. Yeah.
Yeah, if Americans were good at soccer, it would be up there. Just like hockey. It took a little while. Now hockey is dominated by American teams.
And just so as it should be. Screw those Canadians, dude. Burn them.
Hating on soccer... Pickleball's more popular than soccer, you said, right? And now, screw the Canadians.
Screw the Canadians. Screw the Canadians.
You got a song.
Those damn Canadians are too happy all the time. Why are they on fire?
I don't know.
I mean, dude, it like the country of Canada spontaneously combusted a couple of days ago, and the whole country's on fire. I was in Michigan yesterday, and you could see it up there. Bigger than Dallas.
Oh.
It's weird. Oh, yeah. Oh, Canadian. County Manning. Good morning.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, yeah?
Yeah.
What you got? What's going on up there? Who caught you guys on fire?
We're trying real hard to keep these fires under control. But, yeah, they got a little out of control there. Sorry? Yeah.
What were you doing?
Well, we don't know, you know. We don't really smoke, so... They said it was probably caused by lightning.
Yeah.
Yeah, because God is punishing us for not being better at the ice hockey. No. Yeah.
So Canada's burning down because you guys didn't go to the playoffs this year?
Maybe.
Uh-huh.
So, you know, sorry. But, you know, we're trying to control this thing because we're working with Moosehead Beer.
Yeah. Moosehead Beer?
Yeah, and they gave us 4 cases. So if we try and apply it evenly, you know, maybe we'll get those fires down. But I got to tell you, my friend Tom,
what's the matter with Tom?
Is drinking the beers. But he's still putting the beers on the fires, but there's a little 20-minute delay.
Yeah, a little bit for the fire, a little bit for Tom.
Yeah, but, you know, he gives them back. So
oh, I got you.
Taking a while.
I got you.
Yeah.
Hey, Canada man?
Yeah.
I want to know who came in here and changed. You know, I sat up here last night in the studio for an hour and a half and set up all these buttons, and somebody came in and reset it and knocked them all out. I just wanted to know, what would you do, Canada man?
Knocked out.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. Knock out. Like, erased my entire preset screen. Like, where I could play some sound drops funny for you to go around your Canada BS right now.
I don't know.
But it's not there because somebody cleared them all.
Which page?
Did you hit save?
Yeah, I hit save. Which page? All of them.
Know.
Did you do it? Jesus Christ.
I'm not looking at it right now, you know. Can you all hear us, radio listeners?
Yeah, you can, but I mean, y'all want me to come in here and prep for this damn show, and I come up here and for hours until 11 o'clock and set up my whole freaking set of keys, and I come in this morning and it's gone. So who did it?
We don't know.
Wasn't me.
Who did it? John, was it you?
No, sir.
Bobbo, was it you?
No.
Who did it?
I wouldn't even know how.
You loaded the crap I asked you to load?
Yes. And I didn't get rid of anything to load it. There are different pages. Maybe you're looking at
No, I'm looking at S sound effects. It was a full page. And now it's like 4 drops. It was a full page. Now there's 3. Look, I got this.
Blah, 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 blah.
That's all I've got. I just do that all day.
That's appropriate.
Yeah.
It's
blah, 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 blah.
So anytime you hear that, I had a lot of better things planned for this show today.
There's not another page.
No, there's not another page.
I'm sorry to ask.
Where, I mean, here's page B. What do you see? Nothing.
Nothing.
C, D, E, A.
Yeah.
Blah, blah, blah.
Well, that's the only drop you're going to hear all
day,
folks.
That's all I got.
Well, we can get a lot out of that, though.
Yeah.
Go ahead and take us out. 800-800-7234 800-800-RADIO. Next section, I don't need any drops. I don't need anything. Just call in with the cars. I'll bid the cars. I'll just bid the damn cars. I can do that. 800-800-7234 Year, model, make, average, rough, or clean. When you're done, if we make a deal, sell that bitch. I'd play the sell that bitch sounder, but I don't have it, so I can just do this. 800-800-7234 800-800-RADIO. My name's John Clay Wolf by Cars Radio for America's best car buyer. Give me my drops.com.
The John Clay Wolf Show.
What have you got there?
Divine inspiration.
Want more of the John Clay Wolf Show? Check out the largest radio show and fastest growing podcast at jcwshow.com.
This is the John Clay Wolf Show.
John Clay, my man. They say age is just a number, but I've got to tell you, yo. Unicorn trying to fit in with the flamingos. And hey, gee, we all know sickle cell is no laughing matter. But I bet you couldn't even catch it if you tried. Keep doing your thing, girl, now. Let's talk, JD, my friend. You've been everywhere, from movies to TV shows to every radio.
I wrote this.
to the John Clay Wolfe Show.
This is the quick car segment where we bid a couple of cars in the air for our sponsor, GiveMeTheVIN.com. Kim, are you there?
Yes. Hi.
Hi. Where do you live?
Yes. Hi.
Where do you live?
Thousand Oaks.
California. KLOS. Mm-hmm. 95.5. Good morning. So you have an 08 Silverado, three-quarter ton, LTZ diesel, 140,000 miles. It says it's lifted. How much lift? Do you know?
It's not really high, but I mean, I don't know the exact measurement.
Do you know the size of the tires?
It's not crazy. I just put on new tires last year, but
probably
no,
30.
they're not tires. He would have wanted to put the tires bigger, and I didn't, so.
Is he still with us?
So. No, he's not. He passed.
What age?
47 in a terrible ATV accident.
A damn four-wheeler, right?
Yeah, it was a Razor.
A Razor. So,
mm-hmm.
You know, I see people riding those Razors and jumping them like wild. And
yeah, he tried to do a 360. He did a couple of them, and the third one was not the good one.
A 360 meaning like a flip? Or
like
a spin?
Spinning it.
In the
like
air?
Spin.
Or on the ground?
No, on the ground, flat. On the ground flat.
But he was buckled in. It has a roll cage.
He wasn't wearing.
Oh, he wasn't wearing.
Yeah, it does. He wasn't buckled in.
Damn.
No.
I'm sorry.
I know. It was terrible.
Yeah.
Very terrible.
How, God, that's scary. Yeah. Is anybody listening that rides Razors?
Mm-hmm.
You can't even get going without the seatbelts on. If you don't have the seatbelts on, you're not allowed to drive, period. That's the story. That's the rule.
And it shouldn't even start.
Right.
Yeah, I think it shouldn't even start, and a helmet would be necessary, too.
Yeah, the four-wheelers, it's not the four-wheeler wrecks, it's the four-wheelers rolling over on people and killing them, like on offsets.
Yeah, you can break your arm just if it rolled over. I mean, if your arm fell out, you're trying to brace yourself, you're like, they're dangerous. I don't know, people riding still, so.
The truck, is it average, rough, or clean condition?
It's pretty clean. I mean, the body type says PK, so I don't know if that means anything. I told the guy LTZ, but I don't see that on the. I'm looking at the pink slip now, so.
Well, I'm bidding it as an LTZ, so if it's not, we may have to adjust. But I'll give $17,000 for it if it's an LTZ.
Okay, all right.
So you can just go to GiveMeTheVIN.com and load it up, huh?
Oh, so I would put it there? I mean, I don't have to accept your offer right now, right?
No, you just load it in and they'll work it. And when you get pictures and all that stuff. And then, is there a payoff on it?
No, it's totally paid.
So, you live in Thousand Oaks. I think our closest office to you is Burbank, which is about 30 minutes. Is that right?
Yeah. That's not far.
Yeah, we've got an office in Burbank. We've got a person there. We can write you a check for the title and you can go cash it at a Bank of America, or we can do what we call electronic payment and just wire. I mean, it's not a wire, but it's called I forgot what it's called. But anyway, there's these new kind of Zelle payments that we do. And we'll get you paid.
Oh, yes.
We'll get you paid fast is what I'm trying to say.
Thank you.
Yes, ma'am. Go to GiveMeTheVIN.com and load it up. I'm very sorry about your husband.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thanks for listening. Bye. My name is John Clay Wolfe. Buy cars on the radio for America's best car buyer. GiveMeTheVIN.com. Be right back.
Yeah, some people say syndicated shows aren't that good because they don't have that local feel.
Right.
But you don't skyrocket to the number one weekend spot by sucking. Hey, the largest radio show and fastest growing podcast, The John Clay Wolfe Show. Go to jcwshow.com.
Do that. blind man. Sat on the fence, but it don't work.
Keep coming up with love, but it's so slashed and torn.
Show taking over your radio every Saturday morning. Hit him up 800-800-RADIO. Want more of the John Clay Wolf Show? Check out the largest radio show and fastest growing podcast at jcwshow.com. America's number one Saturday morning show, the John Clay Wolf Show.
Said you want to stand there with your arms around me, but I can't feel you. It's kind of like a dream.
Gigi, you look so nice this morning.
Thank you so much. I'm glad you noticed.
What'd you do different?
Let me see. I changed my hair, okay? I got my summer tan going on. You know what I mean? I'm looking a little darker, okay? Looking a little more chocolate, okay?
Looking a little more chocolate.
That's right.
Girl, you look so good, I'd like to sop you up with a biscuit.
Sop me up with a biscuit, baby.
Lord, Lord.
Reverend Charles, you're not supposed to say that to the congregation.
Well, he has lusted in his mind, and that's okay.
Reverend Charles, isn't that against the rules to be looking at a woman in the congregation saying, "You looking so good, I want to"? What brought this up and little Walter's singing about it is my old lady's been on my ass about calling you babe.
Why?
Because I'm not allowed to call other women babe.
I get it.
I do too.
Nobody else calls me that.
I do too. She's like, what if I called, you know, what I did to Bobbo and called him Sugar or something.
Big Daddy.
Big Daddy.
She gonna call him Big Daddy. What's up, Big Daddy?
But back to the preacher, Big Daddy, Reverend Charles.
That's John. That's the things we don't need in the workplace, is to clean everything, get it all, you know, sanitary and nice. If you call Gigi babe, that's not like you being unfaithful. You know. Yo, missus is a fine woman, but I think she began to insert a little bit of the conflagration.
What's that?
The terms of endearment.
Terms of endearment.
Terms of endearment. You know, if you might call Brother Bobbo, you might call him Sugar.
Right.
He is a sweet man.
Daddy.
You know, but your wife feels insecure. You know what you should do?
What?
You should go to that GordonBoswell.com.
Get
some
flowers.
Get some flowers.
Flowers?
Pretty.
How do you
flowers.
Spell flowers?
Pretty flowers for my sweetheart today. Get some pretty flowers from GordonBoswell.com.
Okay.
You spell that with a G and a B.
Okay. Back to you, fiddling, doodling the congregation. What's that all about? You gonna sop up Gigi with a biscuit?
Know, I seen that on a movie. Arsenio Hall played an elder preacher one time in one of those Eddie Murphy movies. I think it was Another 48 Hours or something.
Right.
I like that. When him and Neat Nocti is funny.
Okay.
And she, you know, she look a little like a beautiful biscuit.
Okay, I'll be your beautiful biscuit.
You want to put a little honey on there?
A little honey, a little butter.
Maybe a little butter.
Lots of butter.
You know?
Butter?
You can do a lot of things with a lovely biscuit. That's in the right. Morning. You can sob it over gravy. Mm-hmm. You can cover it with honey. You can nibble your biscuit, or you can
that's right.
You can eat that good-looking son of a gut to only one bite.
Yum, 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 yum,
Reverend yum. Charles, now that we've gotten the church on TV. Oh. Did you know that the church here of the Wolfe Pack is on television now?
No.
Yes. We got cameras in the studio.
How you do that? I've been trying to do that for 40 years.
We got cameras in the studio. Do we have a link on the social media so people can find
we
it?
We do.
Well, hell, you don't need a link. JCW Show. That's all you have to put in. JCW Show. If you want to see Reverend Charles and Gigi, go to jcwshow.com and click Listen Live, Watch Live. And turn down your radio or it'll get all weird on you. Hey, Reverend Charles, we'll get back to you later. Gigi, we'll get back to you in a minute. We need to go to take JD for Pride Month and
what?
Cover the state of Florida.
Pride Month. Now, from North America's own land down under, it's time for Sunshine State News with your certified lifeguard, JD Ryan.
Certainly proud to be your certified lifeguard. All right, a self-proclaimed homeless male model was in a Starbucks in Miami. Pleasuring himself. This is from a woman, by the way, who was able to record the incident firsthand before she called the cops. Cut number six.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. Can you stop? What's wrong with you?
It's disgusting. I don't want to ever go back, and it'll always be in the back of my head.
27-year-old Blake Rain was charged with lewd and lascivious conduct. By the way, his attorney seemed pretty miffed at the whole thing, too. Cut number seven.
Ah, here we go. Public masturbation. In a Starbucks. Why don't you do it at home like the rest of us with a big flat screen TV, 50 channels of pay-per-view? I don't get it. What's the kick?
If you get caught in a Starbucks, you better call Saul, apparently.
It sounded like Saul.
Yes, it did sound like Saul. Guy in Florida with 3 DUIs on his record got another one. What a shock last week when he was driving a lawnmower down a major road. Police released the chest cam footage of him being pulled over. Pull over. Cut number 8.
You know you're in the road, right?
Was I?
You were. How much you have to drink tonight?
A couple.
I think it was a little more than a couple.
Okay, I'm not going to lie to you.
Yeah.
Are you going to take me to jail or not?
No, I didn't say that. I said we're going to do some field sobriety exercises.
I have been drinking.
So I'm going to ask you one more time if you want to do these exercises.
No, sir.
You don't?
Just take me to jail.
All right, Paul. Go ahead and turn around and put your hands behind your back.
Get it over with.
Cut to the chase. Just put me in the paddy wagon and call it a night.
Oh, a day. Look, I know I'm drunk.
I've had a couple.
Are you going to tow my lawnmower?
What's that?
I don't know. What is that?
Oh, it's boy. Jeopardy.
This is Jeopardy.
Okay.
And now it's time to test the intellect and pop culture IQ of our own host, John Clay Wolf, and his gal pal, Gigi.
Yay.
What are we doing?
Now, y'all know how to do this. When you have the answer right, just say ding, ding, ding.
Ooh.
Or do that. I like the sound.
Okay, so
that.
We have to say ding, ding, ding.
Yeah. If you have the answer. We have two categories in today's Wolf Pack Jeopardy. First category is dead presidents. Our second category, he, she, them, or it.
These nuts.
Oh, that's a good category, too.
Here's a category.
Hey, I got something for you. It's called D's Nuts.
Two times on that.
What are those?
In our first category, dead presidents. Here's your question. Ready?
Yeah.
This popular American sitcom that shares its name with the third U.S. president was a spinoff of the award-winning All in the Family.
Ding, 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 ding. What is the Jeffersons?
That is correct, Gigi. Right. Very on. Good. All right.
Okay.
Gigi's nice, on today. Question okay. 2. This domestic American line of vehicles is owned by Ford Motor Company, but shares its name with the man who appears on the $5 bill.
Ding, 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 ding. What is Lincoln?
That is
with
correct.
With the clock in the back.
Right, madam, of my Lincoln, man, okay. Practicing law, okay?
That's right.
That's why they call me Lincoln Lawyer. And our third mm-hmm. question. Not one, but two American presidents have a last name that is very similar to this American beer that invites you to come to the mountains.
Ding, ding, ding.
Yes.
What is Bush?
That is correct. J.D. Ryan sneaks in for some points. Oh, wow. Excellent. Okay, y'all ready for category two?
Sure. Sure.
Category two is he, she, them, or it. Our first question, Bud Light spokesman Dylan Mulvaney has one quality that Bud Light beer does not.
I got it.
I got something for you. It's called D's Nuts.
Well, technically.
That is correct. Our second question. As a legendary athlete, former Wheaties cereal mascot Caitlyn Jenner still has one quality she had when she won the Olympic decathlon in 1976. Yes?
What is a gold medal penis?
That is correct. Very good, John. Wow.
Very nice.
He's cleaning up on this day. And our third question. The cast of RuPaul's Drag Race has a specific numerical advantage over the 80s sitcom The Golden Girls.
What is it again? What do you call it when you want them to?
The cast of RuPaul's Drag Race has a specific numerical advantage over the 80s sitcom The Golden Girls.
Numerical.
I got it. All right. What is a bunch of penis?
That is correct. Very good. And our winner today, John Clay Wolf, sweeps Wolfe Pack Jeopardy. All right, John.
And it's brought to you by America's Best Car Buyer, GiveMeTheVIN.com. I don't know if GiveMeTheVIN wants to be associated with that as a sponsor. We're getting letters from them. They want to look at their branding opportunities in other places.
We're getting complaint letters from our own company.
800-800-7234-800-800-RADIO. My name's John Clay Wolf. Be right back.
Heard on the air every Saturday morning. From New York to Los Angeles to Houston and broadcasting to the rest of the world online at jcwshow.com or johnclaywolf.com. You're listening to The John Clay Wolf Show. Want more of The John Clay Wolf Show? Check out the largest radio show and fastest growing podcast at jcwshow.com. And now back to the John Clay Wolf Show, presented by GiveMeTheVIN.com.
I don't understand these Canadian wildfires, how they all lit at once.
Yeah, it's staggering.
It is staggering.
The pictures you saw of New York City and Washington, like, you know, not so much Washington, but New York City the other day.
I think he's talking about the conspiracy that they all started at the same time. There's satellite footage that shows the smoke all kind of went poof, poof, poof all over the country at the same time. What they're saying was a thunderstorm blew over the country and probably lit them, and then they smoldered for a while.
I know what it was. I know what it is? I just figured it out.
All right.
Pat Robertson, the televangelist.
Yes.
He passed away.
Thursday.
And God was so upset that he lit Canada on fire.
Well, why would... why Canada? Just because.
Just because.
He didn't want to get America, so he just wanted to get close.
What is the... Tell me about Pat Robertson. Cut one.
He was a big part of that televangelist game before a lot of other guys did it. He passed away on Thursday. We put together a little montage of some of his more controversial quotes. You know, he was well known in his later years for saying things that maybe a lot of evangelical pastors wouldn't say. These come from episodes of the 700 Club going way back. And he had some pretty strong opinions. This is cut one.
I think there are... men who are in a woman's body, it's very rare, but it's true, or women that are in men's bodies, that they want a sex change. I don't think there's any sin associated with that. I don't condemn somebody for doing that. Mommy porn. A third of the millions of Americans who watch porn are
women.
Yes.
Who thought
He cheated on you. Well, he's a man. Okay. Give him honor instead of trying to worry about it. What you want to do is to make a home so wonderful that he doesn't want to wander. Why do you build houses in a place where tornadoes are apt to happen?
Not so much why did God send them, but why didn't he intervene?
If enough people were praying, he would intervene. You could pray. Don't blame God for doing something foolish.
Right.
Pat Robertson, is there more of that? I see two here.
He had some strong opinions. One way many of Pat Robertson's original statements got a lot of attention in the last few years was from late night host Jimmy Kimmel, who's been making fun of some of his quotes from the 700 Club for years on his late night talk show. This is Cut One Plus.
We're all going to die. We're all going to die. I'm a great fan of the Total Gym. It is so easy to use. Have you used the Total Gym?
I haven't. I've seen the commercials. I've been tempted to order it.
Don't be tempted. Go get on one. If you want to, you can come up in my attic. You can use mine.
No, no. Don't go to the attic. Just order your own.
Marijuana is a vegetable. Cocaine is a product of a vegetable. Alcohol is a product of a vegetable. Guess what? Crack cocaine. People are enslaved to vegetables. I'm a fan of beans, all kinds of beans.
There you go.
He died?
Ceylon. Godspeed, sir.
How old was he?
93.
I wish they had a heaven tracker. We'd know if he went.
Oh, you know he did. God's got a sense of humor. Come on, Pat.
Yeah, but a lot of those guys live lives that aren't as publicized.
Very true. I have sinned against you, Lord.
Was that Jimmy Swaggart?
Jimmy Swaggart.
Yeah. What was his controversy?
He cheated on his wife. He did a lot of things that were nefarious.
He's a man. Get over
it. He's a man. That's why I cheated. Maybe you should be a better woman.
He had a thing about hookers that nobody knew about. There was a kind of a secret.
Who did? Who's he?
Jimmy Swaggart.
Okay.
There was kind of a secret Jimmy Swaggart.
Allegedly.
Out there.
What kind of thing did he maybe have about hookers?
I don't know, but what was her name? Paula Zahn? The one that he caught that came out that outed him.
Oh.
He had his own
Stormy Daniels?
Yeah, said he was into some kinky things.
Guy liked to have sex with horses.
Now, wasn't there a evangelist story a couple of years ago? It was the Bakers, and they had hookers.
Is that right?
He did,
but she was like rounding them up for him. Donna, what was her name? With Tammy Faye
Baker and her eyelashes.
I don't remember that her rounding up part.
Did you ever watch any of these 700 clubs or?
I mean, I may have seen the 700 Club when they get their little, they sit at the table and they talk about current events and stuff like that, but not very often. Which one was the Teletubby hater?
I don't know.
That was the moral majority guy, Jerry Falwell.
Okay. I knew it was somebody.
What was his problem with that?
He didn't like the Teletubbies. Something about them, you know, having referenced to be gay or something. It was Teletubbies. How are you going to hate on a kid show? So, yeah.
He was trying to be current and relevant, I think, when there was a lot of new technology out there, and he just put the color purple together with a lifestyle choice, and he said, well, you know, the purple one's gay.
In that movie, what am I thinking about? Was it the Baker's movie? Was there
There's a movie.
And wasn't she going out and hustling up the hookers for him?
She was, not that I was aware of, no.
If she was, good way to support your man.
Oh, God.
Did you ever go get your man hookers, Gigi?
Hell no.
Was he a hooker person?
No, I'll be his hooker, but no.
You like talking about your estranged passed away.
Oh, my gosh. Are you kidding me? Remember when they had the 900 calls? The 900 sexy line numbers?
Yes, sure. The one you used to work at?
I went away to have our son. And I came back, and there was a whole bunch of the 976, whatever the numbers were. Mm-hmm. He was like, I didn't do it. I'm like, okay. It was like, I'm going to say $500 or $600 worth. And this is like 1994, so that was a lot. I mean, it's a lot now. So you know what I did?
What?
I called the phone company. I got him to give me the money. And then I called the phone company. He's like, I was not here. I was having a baby. Someone broke into the house and did this. And they gave me a credit, and I kept the money.
All right.
Right on.
They did give you credit?
Yeah, they gave me a credit. They didn't make me pay, but I kept the money. So.
600 worth?
Yeah, it was a lot. Like,
that's crazy. So he calls the 900 numbers, and Gigi winds up with the happy ending.
That's right. Oh. I love it.
We actually have Gigi's ex-husband from the dead here on
He's
the show.
He's back.
Good morning. Come on in.
There he is. Hi, baby.
Hey, how you doing?
Really good. Been playing a little pickleball.
Well, okay. There's nothing little about your pickle, but okay.
Right.
That's all she liked about this guy.
Yeah.
You ain't kidding.
Every time.
He was hung. Every time he comes up, she cusses him, but then she talks about his unit.
I mean, I did have a lot of babies for him, so, you know.
You know, I'm getting
doing
a lot of,
something right.
I'm getting a lot of good instruction, too, on that pickleball.
Oh, okay.
I don't know if you've heard of him. There's a guy, I guess he was like a famous preacher or something, Pat Robertson.
Mm-hmm.
Boy, he's good at pickleball. He's been showing me how to do it. You know what the kitchen is?
The front of the court.
Yep. Can't stand in the kitchen.
If kinda you like can't Gigi. Take the heat, get your ass out the kitchen.
Okay.
Anyway, he showed me how to do it. Those pickleball rackets are a little smaller than you'd probably like. And wiffle balls don't carry any weight, so it's hard to get a good smash bang in there. But I keep on trying.
Okay.
It's good to see you. Thanks for coming down.
Happy in All heaven. Right.
Get out of here. I hear what you're saying, Gigi. He's not that cool.
Mm-hmm.
He was nothing but a stunt.
He was there. He was there. But you know what's really weird?
What?
Like, other than the fact that he abandoned our kids and me, my newest granddaughter is his twin. Like, that's like genetics big time.
And does she have his attitude?
Well, she doesn't like me.
Oh.
You know what I mean? I'm like, if there's a case of reincarnation, that's it.
How old is she?
She'll be 6 months on the 23rd, and everybody else can pick her up and play with her. And, the baby, she looks at me and just breaks out in tears. I don't know why. And I'm like, baby, please, you have to like me. And she's like, no, I'm not doing that. So,
does she look like him?
She looks exactly like him. Like that's his twin. So,
do you believe in reincarnation?
I kind of do, yeah. What are you coming back as?
Bark like a dog for me.
I don't know what I'm coming back as.
Coming back as my friend, damn it.
I hope I come back as...
Yeah, you'll be back.
I'm a ram.
Yeah.
I don't know what I'd want to come back as. If I came back, I just don't know. I can't even... Everything I'm thinking of is not... It's funny, but it'll get us in trouble.
Okay.
I just want to come back as a better person.
Just let me come back. Oh, my goodness.
800-800-7234. 800-800-RADIO. Hey, the fat shot thing. It's really got a lot of people pissed off. You know they're out of it? And
So are you guys not taking it anymore?
No, and I think we need to have a contest of who gains the most weight the fastest.
How do you feel?
I feel fine, but I don't feel like I'm eating that much more, but I do... I haven't got on the scale, but I feel like I'm putting some back on. JD, what
you don't look like it yet.
Thank you.
I'm fine. Maybe it's mental.
It is mental.
I'm really not hungry.
We're talking about semaglutide, that Ozempic kind of deal, but there were offshoots of it. And my friend had some, because Ozempic costs like $1,000 a month or $1,500 a month. And she was doing it for $250.
Correct. Wegovy.
She ran out because she has a conspiracy theory that. And it sounds pretty legit.
I think she's legit.
Yeah, that the big pharma, they want to sell it for $1,500 a month or $1,000.
Of course they do.
They don't like these compounding pharmacies, so they got the FDA to go to the factories that were making it and shut them down for inspections.
Huh.
They haven't claimed any ill will. They haven't said anything's wrong, but they stopped the production. So there's plenty of it, but it's not been released to the pharmacies so that the distributors can get it out to people. But she is getting hate mail from people that started... And she can't deliver it now.
Oh, well, it's not her fault.
No, but she's like, what do I do? People like that were listeners of the show that went to her site because I plugged it.
Sure.
You know, I'm going to take you out. I'm going to expose you.
Oh, that's terrible.
Oh, yeah. All kinds of threats.
Fat people are angry.
Fat people are angry.
I mean, well, you give them something that works and then you take it away and then it's hard. Yeah, that's why I'm scared to take it because, you know, I don't want to... like lose a bunch of weight then gain it back 2 days later when I stopped the shot. So yeah, I'm afraid of that.
Yeah, I'm missing it. I want it back. I need it back. We're gonna come back in a minute. 800-800-7234 800-800-RADIO right after this song.
I don't care if you like a hard top or a soft top. I want to hear some hard rock.
My name's John Clay Wolfe by Cars and Radio from givingmethevin.com.
at GiveMeTheVin.com.
Cool. But you might say that I'm a nymphomaniac, but it keeps me satisfied. Not looking through the mirror, it just tells me something I already know. I'm so cool.
Event to prove a point.
Mm-hmm. Gotcha.
Professional power lifter. This guy entered a women's competition in Canada and smashed a record that was held by a transgender lifter who happened to be competing in the same tournament, which of course was his point, which is if you can beat women, I can beat you. Here's some of the audio from the Fox guy, Greg Gutfield. He's actually a fun evening talk show host. Cut number two.
A male powerlifter recently entered a women's event in Canada and smashed the bench press record held by a trans athlete. But how, you ask, was a guy allowed to compete with women? Turns out in Canada, which Fox has confirmed is a real place, their powerlifting union allows athletes to sign up for any gendered event based on how they feel. No questions asked. Avi Silverberg, who is very much a man, identified as a woman to enter the competition. His goal was simple: show how unfair it is for biological males to compete against women. And boy, did he. Competing in the bench press, Silverberg easily beat the old record by nearly 100 pounds.
Wow.
And so it proves an important point about women's sports, that maybe it's time to take the spotlight off biological men and put it back where it belongs, on lesbians.
Amen.
Go lesbians!
He's so cool, man.
Kind of glad he said it.
Either you get that guy or you don't.
He's great.
Who is he?
Greg Gutfeld. He's been around. Was he ever a stand-up comedian, JD?
I'm sure he did at some point, but he's been kind of a Fox contributor for a long time. Then they gave him his own show, and it just exploded. He's beaten everybody in the ratings.
Yeah. He's one of the smartest guys on the Fox News Channel.
He just comes so prepared. He's got a stack of stuff in his lap, and he just knows.
12 pounds of notes, and he's pretty quick on the fly, but he writes some pretty good dialogue too. So, you know.
Did you see where Tucker Carlson has started his show back on Twitter?
It's Twitter.
After he got kicked off of Fox, and 80 million views.
Really?
Yeah, within 24 hours.
Somebody said Fox is in one and back now. It's one of those, oh, we were, dude, it was well, they're April suing Fools.
Him. They're suing
Fox
him.
News sucks.
They're suing him for breach of contract.
Why?
I don't know.
What'd he do? They
right.
Well, no, he took, so they paid the guy. It's just like a record label, right? Yeah. We signed you to our label. We paid you. And you are not allowed to go play songs other.
No, compete.
Because Fox is going to continue to pay out his contract.
Sure.
And now he's gone over with Elon and he's doing a show on Twitter. Here's the question. It's just Tucker and it's him in his home sitting in front of his computer with a camera talking. Mm-hmm. It's not called the Tucker Carlson Show. They're not taking advertisements. It's just him getting on his... It's a right of speech problem here.
Correct.
Is it a show or is it just Tucker talking? And is that a breach of contract against the contract he has with Fox?
The way broadcast contracts are written now, in the old days they said you couldn't broadcast within 250 miles of the city you were in.
Yeah.
In Dallas-Fort Worth, you can't broadcast within 250 miles for 6 months. The way they're written now is you can't broadcast on any broadcast form created now or in perpetuity. That's the way they lie.
So including online.
Even if they come up with something new, you still can't broadcast.
Can you be on a Zoom call with multiple
users?
That's
stupid.
It is stupid, but and again, it's a fine line of the law.
Oh, it's not stupid at all.
No, it's
put yourself in their shoes.
It's brilliant from the lawyer's perspective.
It's not even brilliant. It's just the fact. They pay this guy.
You're silencing people, and that's not okay.
But you're right. But it's not stupid. It's blatantly capitalist is what it is. And they're not in the news.
Are y'all a bunch of communist pigs? Jesus Christ. Look at it from their viewpoint.
That is their viewpoint.
Yeah.
They're not news
they
friends.
Paid that bitch they're to the be their bitch.
Business.
Right. They paid him to be their bitch. Right. And he said, okay, for this much money, I'll be your boy. So they said, we don't want you on the air anymore because you pissed us off, but we're going to continue to pay you.
Yep.
You're under the deal. So now he's getting on Twitter and he's running his chops. And he's talking smack about them.
Well, of course.
Subliminally.
Oh, is he really?
Yeah. Like, we're going to sue your ass off. And they're going to win.
You think?
But it will turn into a freedom of speech issue.
There's your hook.
Right. And it'll be interesting how it works out. Obviously, he has lawyers, Elon has lawyers, everybody has lawyers, and they've got an opinion, and they went for it.
It's a much better deal than Dave Chappelle got.
It's a much better deal. I forgot what this guy gets paid, but it's $50 million a year, $30 million a year. It's a lot.
A lot of money.
Oh, my gosh. To not work, to not talk. I'll be quiet.
Could you imagine?
I won't say another word.
Right. It's not like he's not getting paid. He's getting his check every week.
Give me $5 million and I will shut up.
800-800-7234. 800.
Mine wasn't $5 million, but we got paid for 2 years after we got pulled off the air.
2 years.
Oh, my gosh.
2 years. Two full years. We'd just gotten a raise, too. It was great.
And you just got paid to do nothing?
For 2 years. Got paid to do nothing.
Did they call you when they sent you your check? You're talking about CBS Radio.
CBS Radio. When I started doing this show, we had to get their permission for me to do this weekend show.
Because you were still getting paid by CBS.
Because I was still getting paid very well by CBS.
Mm-hmm. Huh. Why did they fire you?
I have a story to tell like that. Guy.
My God, the long story short is my co-host got in some legal trouble, and then they decided to change the format and not keep us. So, but our contract said pay or play, and they decided to pay.
All right. Did they offer you a lump?
They did not. They moved us to what we call the David Lee Roth file, which is where they pay people that they want to go away out of New York. So our checks started coming out of CBS New York.
So David Lee Roth, for those of y'all that live under a rock, is the singer for Van Halen, or the old singer for Van Halen. Howard Stern leaves terrestrial radio. He goes to Sirius XM. They have to replace Howard Stern, and they bring on David Lee Roth as his replacement in the central time zone, pretty much.
Correct.
In the Eastern, I believe. And then the West Coast, they brought on Adam Carolla to replace him in L.A., in Vegas, and then a guy named Rover up in Cincinnati. So they had three replacements for David Lee Roth, for Howard Stern. And when I got into radio, I kind of have a... I was, I was a fan of Stern. I listened to that, and this is kind of my delivery, is that open topic, edgy deal. And Stern embarrassed the radio business so much when he left. He left such a gaping hole that they could not fill with listeners nor advertisers, that they wanted nothing else to do with the format. He embarrassed the medium so bad. It's kind of like this Tucker Carlson thing. It's very similar. that they were out. So when I got on CBS Radio and I was wanting to do that style of show, this guy named Tom Bigby just wanted nothing to do with me. He hated me. You're like Stern. You're like Russ Martin, because he just fired Russ Martin.
He just fired Russ Martin.
And JD.
My show, yeah.
Let me tell you something, kid. You need to shut your mouth, or you need to go, or you need to switch to sports radio. The invent of the sports radio coverage across the country occurred when Howard Stern left. Howard Stern created sports radio.
More or less. You're right.
Because when his absence embarrassed the business so much, they had to switch to a new format.
Exactly.
And that was the format, instead of hot shot talk, shock talk, was sports radio. And that we have today.
Because you could still get away with edgy stuff, but you could talk about the Cowboys or the Patriots.
Yeah, no, and those stations and those network stations, you know, ESPN, Mike and Mike in the Morning.
Yep.
They all came to fruition after Stern went away from terrestrial
Gabe
radio.
Hobbs in St. Petersburg, Florida. He's a big radio head. Yeah. And he was working with me, and he was like, John, you're going to have to be a sports talker. If you want to pursue this career, I can't. You're great at what you do, but I cannot get them. They're so
burned,
ass hurt from the Stern hole. Yeah. This isn't going to work. The pain has to go away first. And now it has, and you see that format coming back a bit here and there across the country. Speaking of sports,
do we have any sports?
The Vegas guys are whipping the hell out of the Florida guys in the hockey deal.
Yeah.
Did you guys see what happened with the PGA thing this week? PGA Tour announced.
We don't have time for that, bud.
Oh, we don't
have time.
That's
a big one.
Okay.
We do. I mean, yeah, we can hit it, but we have a lot to do with that. Go ahead and hit the headline. You start. I'm sorry.
PGA Tour announced this week.
See that big clock there?
It's going to merge.
This is 43 seconds.
I can do this in 43.
Okay.
We'll merge with the Saudi Arabian-backed LIV Sports. And they've been at odds. That's why it's a big deal. So we'll talk more about that when we come back after this important message.
From
our sponsor.
Well, what's the important message? Do we have an important message?
We have an amazing message coming up.
Call it. What's that? But the thing's all screwed up. The amazing message is from who died? Pat Robinson?
Yes.
Pray.
Oh, Lord.
Reverend Charles, can you take us out with an amazing message?
Brothers and sisters, please keep your heart light and your eye on the sparrow. We'll be right back with Mo John Clay. We'll show right after this here.
At GiveMeTheVIN.com, we pride ourselves in being America's best car buyer, bringing top dollar for your car with an online process that's fast and easy. But you might not know that we've got a special interest in buying your truck. Luxury haulers, workhorse diesels, or just your favorite pickup truck. We've specialized in putting the right money on your truck longer than anybody. Truck on over to GiveMeTheVIN.com today and get your check on the spot from America's best car and truck buyer.
Sell us your car. GiveMeTheVIN.com. So easy you can do it in your eyes.
Yeah, some people say syndicated shows aren't that good because they don't have that local feel.
Right.
But you don't skyrocket to the number one weekend spot by sucking. Hey, the largest radio show and fastest growing podcast, The John Clay Wolfe Show. Go to jcwshow.com.
There's a party going on right here, a celebration.
to last throughout the years. So bring your good times and your laughter too. We gon' celebrate your party with you. Come on now.
Celebration.
Let's all celebrate and have a good time.
John Clay Wolf Show. Hit him up right now. 1-800-800-RADIO. This is the John Clay Wolf Show.
And this is where we bid a couple of cars for listeners right now for on behalf of GiveMeTheVIN.com. A 13 Yukon Z71. Chris, I didn't think that GMC made a Z71 package. I thought those were always Chevrolets.
No, sir. That's not correct. Nope. I bought this one in January of 14. It's the last one on the lot. It was a 2013 model.
Okay, maybe my brain's just slipping. It's a 13, 10 years old, 100,000 miles. Does 18 grand buy it?
Yes, sir.
Is that too much? I'm just asking. I didn't offer.
You said that real quick.
Right. What's it worth?
It's worth 20.
Oh, so it went up. I shouldn't have asked. What color is it?
Silver.
Sure, it's a Z71 and it's a GMC.
I am 100% sure. I'll send you pictures of it. It's Z71 four-wheel drive with towing package.
Average MMR is 13.5, unless I'm reading this wrong. Z71. Huh. Go to GiveMeTheVIN.com, load this one up. Let me look at it, because I don't want to waste too much time trying to figure out what it is. Brian, you've got an 11 Mini Cooper hardtop coupe?
Yes.
How many miles?
31,400.
What color?
Red with a black top.
$8,000.
Okay, seems a little low, but understand.
I'm just telling you, everybody's going to think everything's a little low based off of the old market. It is coming down. You know, the COVID market.
I'm not thinking on that. I guess I'm basing it more on what's out there online right now. The same car with twice the miles is going between 12 and 17.
Well, I'm looking at auction results, which are actual transactions recent. And you might be right. Hold on. Here's one with 46,000 miles that sold 2 weeks ago in California. Actually, we sold it in our California lane for $7,750. And then here's one that sold for $2,800, but it's probably wrecked. Here's one that brought $7,000 with 48,000 miles May 18th in Seattle. And here's one with 60,000 miles that brought $5,500 in Dallas, but it had a low CR grade. What did I tell you? Yours was worth seven?
Eight.
Okay, I think I'm all over it. I'll give $8,000 if it's nice. All right, go to GiveMeTheVIN.com, load it up. Thank you. Anybody else like to sell their car, go to GiveMeTheVIN.com. It's all electronic, digital. We'll give you a bid automatically. Actual humans will talk to you or text with you. It's not just robotic. We'll give you a number robotic real quick so you have a number, and then we'll work it out from there. Look at our reviews for GiveMeTheVIN.com. Better Business Bureau, 4 stars. 4 stars. It's hard to do in the car thing. Google reviews, Facebook reviews, every reviews. There's thousands of them out there. GiveMeTheVIN.com. America's best car buyer for that one reason. I'll just stand on that right there. Our reviews, what our customers say. Look it up. Love to do business with you. Be right back.
Broadcasting on air, online, anywhere you are, with a smartphone and an internet connection. Check out the podcast, jcwshow.com or johnclaywolf.com.
One, two, three, four. Sounds so good tonight. Hey. I'm so tired of being alone. I'm so tired of on my own. Won't you have me, girl, just as soon as you can? Yeah, and people say, make you say that you love me. Yeah, you didn't go over that, no. It's a matter of fact that I wanna come back, won't you show me where? Just thinking about it, but oh my, you see, I'm tired of being all wrapped up
in my dreams every night without you, baby. Here sometime I wonder. Oh, I sit down and I wonder. Chicago, I wonder if you love me, love me, love me. If the girl really love me, if she love me just like she says she do. Cause I've been thinking about it. I've been thinking about your love, baby. And ooh, baby, sometime after fold my arms and that
1 minute.
John Clay Wolfe Show. Heard every Saturday morning across America. Call in 800-800-RADIO. 800-800-RADIO. Check out the podcast at jcwshow.com or johnclaywolfe.com. This is the John Clay Wolfe Show.
Go, Gigi. Look at her on the camera. She's
going. You guys
going.
Are just playing all the hits today.
I have never seen you get going like that. You know, this reminds me. I go to a party, a debutante party.
Oh.
2 weeks ago, and a debutante party, for those of y'all who don't know, is like when a woman's of age, 21 years old, to be married off. It's a party where you push your daughter out there to society for somebody to marry. It's an old thing, but really now, it's just, in these days, it's just an excuse to have a good party.
Yeah, the coming out party.
Right. So, I need some more of that music to do this story. You got any more? I mean, without Casey and the Sunshine Band, I can't even talk about it.
It does something to you, doesn't it?
It does. It really does. So, so the gal invites all of her friends, and then the parents invite their friends, and it's a big party. And they had a DJ from Florida come in, and these kids are doing their thing. But I noticed after midnight, all the pansy-ass kids went home from midnight till 1:30, there was nothing on the dance floor except 50 plus.
Mm-hmm. It was a good time.
But it's just so, they're just so soft.
What?
How did kids get so soft?
Oh.
This party was for them. It's all nighter, right?
Going to bed early.
And they tap out at midnight, and then all the parents are out there, the ones drinking hard and dancing hard until 2 in the morning. There was no kids left.
I know.
This was for them. It's the damnedest
it's
thing.
It's a different life. Mm-hmm. My kids are older and they go to bed early. 8:30, 9, 10. What are you doing?
Soft. They're just soft.
It's because your kids weren't repressed, you know. And my parents had a strong hold on me, like discipline and schedule wise, activity wise.
Right.
And repression will create rebellion every time. And I was a wild MRF-er, man.
I bet you were.
That's what happened to me.
So
you still are.
For you guys that don't know, we have the stream up with the video now. So if you go to jcwshow.com, you can see the video link of the studio in here. And the camera switch between who's talking. And it's Gigi's in here. But we get some, you know, we have you just lost a listener. You just lost a viewer email.
You just lost a viewer. Listener.
Pre-K, are you there?
Sir.
Hey, good morning, good morning, good morning.
Morning. Yeah, we got a live one, man. I love being on camera, you know, with y'all. But apparently some people, let me just read it, okay? This guy, Greg, out in Tampa Bay, Florida, said, I listen on 98 Rock here in Tampa every week, and I love the show. Hell yeah, Greg. Decided to check out the live stream video tonight on YouTube just to see how it is since you've been promoting it. I was surprised by how fat you guys are in the studio. But in parentheses, he said, Gigi's head looks great.
Ooh, thank you.
You don't sound like fat guys on the radio. I was absolutely shocked by one thing, though. I cannot believe that DJ Pre-K is an actual human being. I would have bet my ass that he was a character that Turley slips into when needed. Anyway, keep up the good work. Maybe eat a salad every now and then and exercise a little.
You just lost a listener.
I mean, the camera.
Hate to appreciate, right? Man, I guess.
Haters going to hate. Like that.
The old joke, the camera puts on 20 pounds. Really? Well, how many cameras you got on you?
Yeah. Right.
Turley, why does he think that you didn't you used to do a homeboy on the street bit?
Yeah, I don't know if he's a listener from that deal. Way back in the day, yeah. But yeah, you used to do a man on the street bit where, you know, I was a white black guy, basically.
A pre-K.
Yeah, pre-K, before pre-K, yeah. And I would interview different athletes and stuff, and actually found one of my archived interviews, if you want to hear it.
I do. So set it up.
So bad. All right. So this was, I used to take trips down to boxing events in Vegas, and HBO would pay for it and go down there and interview the boxers.
Okay.
And this time it was Sugar Shane Mosley versus Winky Wright.
Really?
The 154 unified belt fight. It was a huge, huge event back
Sugar
in 2004.
Sugar Shane Mosley was a badass.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, he had a belt, and Winky Wright had belts, so they're going to unify it at 154, the weight class. Well, you know, I was down there. Let's do some bits. And I forgot my name of my guy here, but I guess my alter ego is called Big T.
Big T.
Oh, Big T.
It's funny, but it's so embarrassing now listening back. This is 2004. Me interviewing Sugar Shane Mosley.
All right, dog. Big T here with my big dog, Sugar Shane. How you doing, man?
I'm doing great, man. Doing good.
Dog, all right. What's the 411 on your nickname?
Sugar Shane Mosley?
Yeah. You too?
Oh, that happened when I was like 9 years old.
Okay.
Wow, you're like little Sugar Ray. We're going to call you Sugar Shane. From then on, I was Sugar Shane.
Man, I feel. You know what? They call me Big T because I'm big dog. And my last name's Turley. It makes sense, you know?
Oh, okay, me too. Yeah, me too.
So, man, how'd you get that lovely lady? How'd you get her?
Is it my wife?
Yeah.
Oh, I met her in New York, and, you know, we talked for a little bit, and I was just, I guess I flew out here to California, and from then on, we was together.
Yeah. You know what, dog, though? There's got to be one lady out there, though. There's one other lady that you wish you have. Who'd that be?
Nah, none of that.
You know what? See, I'm the same way too, dog. Yeah. Me too. I feel you on that one right there. I feel you there.
Sorry.
Yeah, pause it.
No. Who that be?
Who that be?
Yeah.
Who that be? Quien es esta niña? Who that be?
Hey, I was in character, all right?
So the ducats must be flowing in now, right?
Can you pause it again?
So what
Pre-K, do you have any commentary for Turley's impersonation of you? That's what I'm hearing.
I mean, I don't hear nothing wrong with it. I think his interview skills are perfect. You know? Yeah, who'd that be?
You are very fly, Turley.
Yeah.
Turley taps into the black side.
What type of spinners you rolling on?
Oh, God.
I don't have any spinners, but you know, I'm rolling some dubs, 22s.
Ooh, 22s?
Yeah, I got some 22s here. Mm-hmm. You know, that's from way back. I kind of left alone a little bit, but, you know, I got some on my Escalade. Yeah.
Yeah, you know what, dog? I'm rolling tight at night, though. Tight at night with 15-inch rims. Man, I keep them clean, too.
Oh, definitely?
Yeah, I keep them clean.
Cool.
So what type of car are you rolling with?
Escalade, you said?
Oh, I have an Escalade, you know, Mercedes, Sage G-Wagon, you know, so like, I got about 3 cars.
Ooh, man, dog, you know what I'm rolling with, man? I'm rolling with the K&N filter on my 3.8 V6. Ooh, it's going.
Going down.
I was supposed to say van there, but I forgot to say that. I was getting a little too much.
K&N filter! On a van. That is a reach!
Oh, no.
Yes, man. Yeah, dog, I bet your crib's off the heezy, isn't it?
Nice.
Oh. Stop!
Yeah, what kind of
stop! Uh-huh. Pre-K, can you translate?
What you say? I bet your crib is off the heezy.
Yeah,
off the heezy.
This is 2004, okay?
Well, that means that I'd be assured that your house is really nice.
Yes.
Your crib
is great.
Is off the heezy.
I just love tight at night.
What is tight at night?
It's just tight, man. You know, I don't know. This is 2004 with Sugar Shane Mosley.
Where has this audio been for 20 years?
Go ahead.
What you got?
Everybody good. Almost 10,000.
Woo, man. Man, I got the 600-foot, one-bedroom, one-bath crib, dog. All bills paid, too.
Yeah, me too.
Oh, yeah. Hey, see, look at that. Same thing, man. So, yo, dog, that lovely lady you got, she must have got with you because you're knocking all those haters out like you're going to do with Winky, right?
Oh, definitely, definitely. But not only that, you know, before I was even me, before she even knew it was me, It was a good thing, you know. She just knew that I was one.
Yeah, but she also likes you because you're gonna knock them haters out like you're gonna do the Winky tomorrow or Saturday.
Oh, definitely, definitely. Yeah. She knows. I mean, all the haters out there, gonna put man.
You put them out.
Oh man, it's gonna be nice. There's so many haters, but it's gonna be cool though.
Yes. Did he win?
Yes. You know what, no. Dog? I got my lady. Because she's the most wonderful woman in the world.
Ah!
She's special to me.
I had to go white.
I love her. I love you, babe. Kisses. Yeah, dog. You got some major bling, too, don't you? I know you do.
So we had a pre-K before pre-K came on the show.
Big T.
That's why I think I liked pre-K so much. It's like, dude,
I don't have to do it anymore.
No, I don't have to do this anymore.
That is nothing but blatant appropriation.
Hey, I want to grab AJ real quick because he's got a pretty weird car. AJ, are you there? AJ, are you there? AJ in Austin with the M5.
Hello?
AJ, hello.
Hello?
Yo, hey, how's it going?
Good. Yo. Are you tight at night rolling on 15 spinners?
Am I?
Yeah.
Definitely not, man. I'm sticking with my OEM, E39 M5 setup staggered. Can't argue, man.
So you have a 2002 20-year-old M5 BMW, and it has 150...
Yes, sir, I'm driving it right now.
140,000 miles. What color is it?
It's titanium silver.
How long have you had it?
I purchased this vehicle at the end of the year last year. Just so to give you a little bit of color as to my buying criteria at the time, I've owned 7 M5s, a couple M3s, and an M6. And I was on the hunt for an LCI M5. Mm-hmm. You know, one of the newer models that had some of the timing chain issues kind of squared away from the factory. And
okay.
I picked it up, and it needed some work. I fixed the valve cover gaskets, tensioners, belts, did full service, resealed the rear differential. And I think that's it. But, and I refinished the wheels.
Hey, will y'all wake me up when he's done talking?
Sure.
Okay. Hey, dog, man, we got to go to break.
Yeah, we got to go to break. I'm trying to buy your car, but you won't shut up and let me buy it.
All right, let's hear it.
20 grand.
Wow.
Nah, not happening, my man. I could flip this thing up, bring a trailer tomorrow for 29.
Then do that. My name's John Clay Wolf. I buy cars on the radio for America's Best Car Buyer. Give me the VIN.com.
At GiveMeTheVIN.com, we pride ourselves in being America's best car buyer, bringing top dollar for your car with an online process that's fast and easy. But you might not know that we've got a special interest in buying your truck. Luxury haulers, workhorse diesels, or just your favorite pickup truck. We've specialized in putting the right money on your truck longer than anybody. Truck on over to GiveMeTheVIN.com today and get your check on the spot from America's best car and truck buyer.
Sell us your car. GiveMeTheVIN.com.
John Clay Wolf Show.
KCWShow.com.
The number one weekend morning show in America.
JohnClayWolf.com.
Tastes good.
Hey, want more John Clay Wolf? Go to JCWShow.com for the fastest growing podcast in the U.S.
Still the same. Your love is strong, it's still.
This is Gigi with the John Clay Wolfe Radio.
Why do I go to pre-K on that? I should go to Gigi. She knows more Snoop Dogg than pre-K. He's a faker. I don't know.
That's my black soul brother.
Snoop Dogg. I have not heard this yet. It is recorded here. I'm looking forward to it. Is it funny? Have you heard it, Bob?
I think it's pretty funny. Yeah.
I'm excited.
Snoop Dogg did something for us specifically?
Yeah.
Okay.
A friend of mine hooked it up. Listen, okay. So it's supposed to be... Am I light? Is my mic light?
No.
It sounds normal? Okay, it sounds... I just need to turn up my headphones a little bit. 800-800-7234. 800-800-RADIO is the call-in number. Before I do that, I'm going to jump real quick to this. Dwight. You there? Dwight. Dodge Ram Dwight.
Yes.
Real quick, 19...
I can barely hear you.
All right, 19 Dodge Ram Mega Cab. You want... 46,000 for it. It's got 35,000 miles. Is it average, rough, or clean?
Excellent. I'll
give 46.
Like brand new.
I'll give 46.
You will.
I will. It's a four-wheel drive, right?
Four-wheel drive, mega cab, black on black, black, nice custom Dodge black top.
Blacker than DJ Pre-K. It's blacker than DJ Pre-K. Pre-K, grab line one and get Dwight. Okay, 800-800-7234. Snoop Dogg, roast, the JCW show. I have not heard this. Let's see what we got.
Yo, yo, what's cracking? It's your boy Snoop Dogg up in the house. And I've got to give a big shout out to my homie John Clay Wolfe for inviting me to this legendary radio show today. And you know I'm always down to bring the heat. So without further ado, we about to get this roast started. John Clay, my man, they say age is just a number, but I've got to tell you, your old lady was probably still learning how to tie shoelaces while you were walking across that graduation stage.
Uh-oh.
She's so young, when you two get into a real fight, I wouldn't be surprised if I have to call CPS before the police just to check if everything's all right. They say love has no bounds, but my man, the schoolyard only goes so far. And JCW, my dude, I gotta give you props for keeping the adrenaline pumping with those dirt bike adventures. But seriously, I mean, after your most recent motorbike accident, you came out with several broken ribs and a broken collarbone. John, you've got more cracks in your body than a sidewalk after a California earthquake and more hardware in you than a Home Depot.
God. Wow.
Here's him on Gigi.
Now, let's talk about Gigi. She's got that black chocolate voice, smooth and tempting. But here's the thing, with all that Trump stuff she says, we're still scratching our heads. It's like watching a unicorn trying to fit in with the flamingos. And hey, gee, we all know sickle cell is no laughing matter. But I bet you couldn't even catch it if you tried. Keep doing your thing, girl, and keep us guessing.
No, what was that? I don't get it. Gigi, what was he saying?
Because sickle cell is for black people.
Right.
And he said, so he's questioning my ethnicity.
Oh, he's saying you couldn't catch sickle cell. You said why you couldn't catch
That's
sickle
right.
cell. J.D. Ryan.
Oh, no.
Here's Snoop Dogg's comments on you.
J.D., my friend, you've been everywhere from movies to TV shows to every radio station in Dallas. But hey, when they took the live boat off the air, did your career take a dive too? J.D., you've got more on-screen appearances than a Kardashian has selfies. I guess the camera just can't get enough of your charismatic charm.
Jeez. Wow.
I think he meant the love boat, not the live boat.
Love boat.
Huh.
He liked me. He liked me. He really
he
liked
likes
me.
You. We all like
Here's
you.
Bobbo. Here's what Snoop thinks about Bobbo.
Now, let's turn our attention to Bobbo, the singer with the funny impersonations. What? He smokes a pack of cigarettes a day to get that perfect radio sound. I don't know if Bobbo is impersonating Keith Richards or if Keith Richards is impersonating Bobbo. Huh. And we can't forget about the Reverend Charles, Randy Chipmunk, and Hanna the Stripper. Chipmunk. It's like you've got a whole circus of personalities, Bobbo. Hey, as long as you're treating those multiple personalities with the chronic, who am I to judge?
With the chronic?
Okay. Okay.
All right. Snoop Dogg on Pre-K.
DJ Pre-Kano, my man, you're the flip side of GG. You're as white as fresh snow, but your rhythm is so black, it's like you've been baptized in soul. You make M&M and Vanilla Ice look like they've been bleached in comparison. I mean, who needs a melanin boost when you've got DJ Pre-Kano spinning the beats? Keep breaking those stereotypes, my man, and keep bringing the rhythm to the airwaves.
And here is Snoop Dogg on Turley.
And finally, Turley the Jew, now that your band spot has come into the limelight on the JCW...
If y'all cut him off, he can't hear what he's saying. He said Turley the Jew. Let's start him over.
And finally, Turley the Jew, now that your band spot has come into the limelight on the JCW show video stream, we can finally see your true colors shine. But hey, with that spotlight on your head, I think it's time to consider covering it up with a yarmulke. Embrace your heritage, my man, and let the world know that you're proud to be Turley the Jew, Mazel Tov.
Oh my God.
Mazel Tov.
Okay,
Mazel
so tov. What do you think about that, Gigi?
I love it. It was good.
All right.
Yeah, it was good.
Turley the Jew.
Did it sound weird to you?
It sounded a little bit strange, mm-hmm. but kind of sounds like him a lot.
So do you know that that's fake?
Well, I mean, you know, you can kind of tell a little bit.
Right.
Bobbo.
But
Bobbo.
So that was not Snoop Dogg. That was ChatGPT.
And it wasn't me, Bobbo, either.
That was ChatGPT.
They'll make it sound like anybody?
That whole thing
was ChatGPT.
But how did you do that?
I did not. A friend of mine did it. And he showed me a deal he did. And I said, do that on us. I mean, it's crazy. That is insane. Now, I mean, obviously, a perfected ear would pick up on it immediately. Mm-hmm. But you know they're going to get it perfect.
But they've got the Tom Cruise deep fakes that look so amazing.
Yeah, those videos and stuff.
Yeah, the videos. But this is,
those are awesome.
Yeah, you're right. They're going to smooth this out.
Right.
And you'll never know what's real and what's not real anymore. Did you hear what Biden said? Did you hear what Trump said? How do we know?
I mean, listen close. You'll obviously tell that it's fake, but damn.
Yo, what's cracking? It's your boy Snoop Dogg up in the house.
And know that he didn't put all that in there. ChatGPT did this.
Did all of it.
He put the jokes in there.
Sure.
But ChatGPT did it in Snoop Dogg's voice with Snoop Dogg style.
Yo, what's cracking? It's your boy Snoop Dogg up in the house. And I've got to give a big shout out to my homie John Clay Wolfe for inviting me to this legendary radio show today. And you know I'm always down to bring the heat. So without further ado, we about to get this roast started. John Clay, my man, they say age is just a number, but I've got to tell you, your old lady was probably still learning how to tie shoelaces while you were walking across that graduation stage. She's so young, when you two get into a real fight, I wouldn't be surprised if I have to call CPS before the police just to check if everything's all right.
Gotta call CPS. Because she's a kid.
His inflection's perfect, but his timing's a little off. There's some things that AI doesn't understand about human nature
yet.
Like, you know.
Yeah, give it time. It'll understand.
Have you seen some of the paintings and portraits and things they've done with AI?
Yeah.
You know, they're like,
beautiful.
There's a man with his hands on his knees sitting on a chair across the room from a woman. And if you look closely, he's got two thumbs on his right hand.
Oh, jeez.
Like, they just, you know.
Pre-K is what's weird is, you know, because pre-K has that kind of style anyway, in the way that I think his sounds the most realist.
Maybe. DJ Precano, my man, you're the flip side of Gigi. You're as white as fresh snow, but your rhythm is so black, it's like you've been baptized in soul. You make M&M and Vanilla Ice look like they've been bleached in comparison. I mean, who needs a melanin boost when you've got DJ Precano spinning the beats? Keep breaking those stereotypes, my man, and keep bringing the rhythm to the airwaves.
Blah, 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 blah.
Stereotypes, my man. Right. Yeah,
it just needs tweaking.
End phrasing.
We were going to have Tupac, but he didn't show up.
They could do Tupac?
Yeah, they could do anybody.
Not anymore.
Like somebody just did Tupac.
Biggie did Tupac. Wasn't that the deal? 800-800-7234. 800-800-RADIO. Dave in Cincinnati.
So Dave.
Whoa, can you hear me?
And I'm going to sell it. Dave? It helps people do this.
He can't hear me?
He's not listening. He's talking to his friends.
Dave is born.
I'm going to be on the radio.
Dave is ready.
Nick in North Carolina. I'm going to bid a couple cars real quick. For GiveMeTheVIN.com. 14,
how are you?
14 Fusion. I'm good. What city in North Carolina?
Okay, you're going to have to repeat that because I'm a little hard of hearing. Please and thank you.
What city in North Carolina?
It's actually a town. It was incorporated in 1905, and it goes by the name of Garner. That's G-A-N. Wait, because I'm dyslexic. Hold on. G-A-R. Yeah, see? You think I caught that? G-A-R-N-E-R, North Carolina. Currently the known hometown of one Scotty McCreary, nationally recognized recording artist.
Okay. So, real quick, a 14 Ford Fusion, SE, 94,000 miles Ford Fusion. Which engine? Is it the 6 or the four-cylinder?
Got the 1.5-liter EcoBoost
chicka,
engine.
Chicka. $4,000. Jonathan, Florida.
Yes.
This one's going to take too long. I do want to buy it, though. So go to GiveMeTheVIN.com and load it up. Dwight, we already bought your truck.
Oh.
Dwight. You there? Dwight. Pre-K grab Dwight. We bought his truck 10 minutes ago. He's calling back about nothing. Michelangelo in Florida, what you want? They can't hear me. I'll be damned. All right. I'm going to try to get the phone thing fixed. 800-800-7234. 800-800-RADIO. This show is brought to you by America's best car buyer, GiveMeTheVIN.com. If GiveMeTheVIN does not beat your CarMax offer, written CarMax offer, they will send you a check for $100 signed by me to your house. So you'll either get $100 or $1,000 or $2,000 or $3,000 more from GiveMeTheVIN.com. It's worth your time. Market's slipping a little bit, but Give Me the VIN is still on top of it. Go to givemethevin.com. You can load your car up and get an automated bid in 60 seconds, and the buyer will be right behind the automated bid to discuss it with you and work out. You know, we can't really add options digitally and conditions. So nice cars are worth more money. It's just that simple. Go to givemethevin.com. We'll do a custom buy on your car. Pick it up. Give you a check. Give you a wire or an EFT or whatever it's called. Be right back.
We'll be right back.
minute.
It's time for the John Clay Wolfe Show. Presented by GiveMeTheVin.com. Call John, toll free, 1-800-800-RADIO. And check out the podcast at JCWShow.com. Give me the Vin! Is there
nothing I can say, nothing I can do? Mike, you gotta bring it up just a touch. 800-800-7234, 800-800-RADIO. My name's John Clay Wolfe, got J.D. Ryan.
Hey!
Gigi.
Good morning.
Bob.
Yeah, yeah.
Turley, pre-K. What's crackling? What's happening, everybody? Mike, can you catch us up real quick on the sports for those who don't watch them?
Have you been watching any of it?
Not this week.
You're not missing much.
Okay.
Nuggets, like I talked about, they're going to have the gentleman sweep. They won last night, 108-95. And they didn't even really need Jokic. They had their role players actually step up for them. And so now they'll go back to Denver. They'll win it and... Hey, everybody, the Denver Nuggets. Are you excited they're going to be the world champions?
Go Denver.
How about it?
But, you know, we always need like a white European winning a championship every once in a while, right?
That's like Dirk? Great.
Yeah, like
it's
Dirk.
It's been a while. What's it been, 12 years, 13 years?
Turley sent me this week. There's a guy named Drew Z that does neat little videos. Many of them are musically oriented. And he did something that he dedicated to what he called, quote, the most scrappy, gritty, good fundamentals players in the NBA. It's got number 4.
White American NBA players. They got podcasts. They got nice hair. Spot up shooters who get hounded on defense. Assuming that they went to Duke is not a crazy pretense. White American NBA players. When you inbound pass, you better beware. They come off the bench. They're the energy guys. Your uncle's favorite player, but you don't ask why. White American. White American. White American. The European white guys are scary.
White American European black guys?
Are
white
scary.
Guys are scary.
Oh, okay.
They come off the bench with energy. Yeah. What was his name? Mavericks. Dallas Mavericks. Like years ago, the little guy that everybody loved.
Jet? No.
3-point shooting, yeah. Son of a gun, man.
Well, he wasn't white. You're talking about...
He's Mexican, wasn't he?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
From Puerto
yeah.
Rico. I can't remember his name.
That's fine. Anyway. It's close enough.
Right? He was the energy guy.
Right, the energy
guy. Which is
guy.
The white guy.
What was his name? I don't remember. 800-800-7234, 800-800-RADIO. Remember, you can go to the live video stream and see us in the studio now, and in the audio's there too at jcwshow.com. It is time... We've got mail from jail coming up with Johnny Cash. But right now it is time for the world's largest son of a bitch.
His father-in-law recently called him a pedophile just because his wife is 22 years old and he's 36, which completely ruined their 10th anniversary. The nicest thing he can say about his wife's side of the family? Get all 15 of them together and you'll finally have a full set of teeth. His standby philosophy for dating new women? Treat them like a new linoleum floor. If you lay them correctly the first time, you can walk all over them for 30 years. He is the world's biggest son of a bitch.
Hey man, I don't always drink beer, but when I do, make mine a Natty Light Tall Boy.
Yeah, buddy!
That's a pretty good joke, the linoleum floor. Where'd you find that?
Huh?
Did you come up with that or did you find it somewhere? The linoleum floor.
Well, I'm just writing down what he says. I'm just a conduit for the wisdom.
Who's that? Oh, Johnny. Johnny Cash. Johnny. Johnny, come on in.
Hello, I'm Johnny Cash.
Hey, Johnny Cash.
Still getting used to this room, John.
I like it.
You know, you really ought to have a picture of me and Willie and Waylon and old Chris Christopherson somewhere.
I would agree with that. Bob needs to grab that.
You're always better in the company of highwaymen.
Highwaymen.
In my opinion. This week's letter reads, howdy, partners. I'm not a Texan, but I do love the southwesty flavor you guys bring to the radio every Saturday morning. I'm currently housed in the Arizona State Prison Complex. My name's Rowdy, by the way. I love to listen before I got locked down. I've listened for years. I've even called the show a few times. You probably remember me. You're probably wondering how a smart man like me got in here.
How many people named Rowdy wind up in jail? Go ahead.
All of them.
Yeah. All of them.
I worked in my father's rug cleaning business since I was a teenager, but when the pandemic hit, we lost a lot of business, and I lost my job. So I started selling reefer. Good reefer. Unfortunately, I was a little overly ambitious, and before long, I was selling good Colombian weed by the pound to some Mormons up in Utah. Till I got busted by a narc, and that sumbitch was not even a Mormon. I think he's probably a Scientologist. Anyway, they caught me for a legal sale of 115 pounds. That's quite a bit. And now I'm in here for at least 9 years on a 12-year minimum. But luckily, it's much easier to sell marijuana in the joint than it ever was out in the world. And you better know I'm all about it. A man can't just sit around. Am I right?
You're right.
Anyway, if you read this, please give a shout out to my homies out in Tucson. Tell that gal Gigi she must be beautiful. She sure sounds like.
Well, you can see her at jcwshow.com and click the video feed.
Not allowed in prison, John. Ain't that a bitch? Anyway, over and out, pard. Smoke it if you got it, while you got it.
Thank you, Johnny.
Your friend, Rowdy Brackens, Arizona State Prison Complex. Phoenix.
So, thank you, Johnny. Tiger King. Joe
Exotic.
Exotic. I was thinking Maldonado Passage. Yeah.
Yeah.
He was calling in every Saturday at 10:05, and then they cut him off.
Well, he ran out of minutes.
Like T-Mobile minutes?
Yeah, he only gets 300 minutes a month, and when he runs out, he can't make phone calls until the 16th.
Of June?
Of June.
So we'll have him back next week.
We will have him back.
All right. So that's our other mail from jail. Speaking of jail, Dr. Trump is indicted. And
doctor?
I'm being sarcastic. 33 counts or 35 counts or 30-something counts of...
Seven counts, what?
Whatever it is. What did he do wrong? He brought all the docs home to Mar-a-Lago.
Well, there's been a lot of that going around, actually. The current president, Joe Biden, had a spell of that. Also, the previous vice president, Michael Pence, Obama, had
like
a few
deflection.
Documents when he got home.
Did you see Bobbo, like, protecting Trump? What's going on?
No, I'm just saying, but here's the deal. When they realized they had him, they immediately gave him back. But Donald Trump was asked for these things for, like, a year. He was even subpoenaed for him, and he didn't give him back. So he's kind of asking for trouble. But... lucky for Trump, I'll say, just like I said for Michael Jackson years ago, they're not going to put that white woman in jail. So it'll be all right.
Very nice.
Nobody's going to put that old white woman in jail.
Mm-mm. So Trump's not going to prison?
Nope.
I don't know. Who does?
Well, I've got a clip here of him in prison.
Martha Stewart is the only celebrity I remember going to
ever.
Jail.
Ever.
Okay, folks, listen up. This is the greatest prison you've ever seen. The walls are huge, just like my buildings. Tremendous walls, and let me tell you, the food here, it's fantastic. We have the best prison food, the most beautiful meatloaf, the most tremendous mashed potatoes. I've even made a deal with the warden to have gold-plated toilet in my cell, because that, my friends, is how I roll. It's luxury behind bars, believe me. And you know what? I've even started my own prison reality show. It's called The Apprentice, Cell Block Edition. It's going to be huge. Ratings, through the roof, just like my hair.
Outstanding.
Step getting fired. You're released.
You're released. Wildfires coming down from Canada are taking over America. The Canadians are trying to burn the White House down again. Didn't know if you were aware of that.
Just the whole Northeast is orange. It looks like Mars.
It looks like Trump's hair.
Somebody's photoshopped a Mars rover in New York.
Maybe that's what it is. Maybe it's...
That's so surreal. You know how you watch the... I don't know if you guys, like, when you're getting ready for work in the morning, I have the news going on in the living room. I can hear it, you know, but I can't see it. And I hear him talking about, oh, this, just look at the air quality. Just look at the sky. Just, oh, you can't believe over New York City. And I thought, you know, they're always saying that, right? All this air quality bad. You see it every time you turn on your car stereo.
All the time.
Right? And I walk into the living room just passively on my way to the coffee pot.
So boring.
And I turn to the TV and I'm like, oh my God.
It looks like Mars.
Is that the Empire State Building? That looks like a Godzilla movie from the early 60s, man. It's like end of the world. The monsters are coming.
It's so true.
It's like The Mist with Stephen King, you know? God.
Quinn in Royce City, you have a comment from earlier back in the show?
Yeah, hey, I wanted to call. Yeah. I wanted to call because I wanted to back up Turley on saying heezy instead of for house.
Right.
My whole family still says heezy for house. In fact, if we ever want to go to Waffle House, we just say, hey, you want to go to the heezy? And the answer is always faux sheezy.
Okay, thank you, Quinn.
Well, of course he said it right. Are you insinuating that Turley wouldn't have his hip-hop language correct?
800-800-7234.
800-800-RADIO. Don't be fronting, dog.
Is the call-in number. Dude, we're going the next fly. Segment. The next segment is cars, where we'll bid cars on the radio right here for America's Best Car Buyer to you. Give me the VIN. Give me the VIN. GiveMeTheVIN.com. Call in right now. We've got the phones working properly. 800-800-7234. 800-800-RADIO. Year, make, model, miles, average, rough, or claim. My name's John Clay. We'll be right back after this song.
Not look like it.
Listening.
But we are actually kind of hip.
To the John Clay Wolfe Show.
Why does it have to be so loud?
And check out the podcast at jcwshow.com or johnclaywolfe.com.
Check. Well, no. It's not that. The call, when we went through this before, the callers couldn't hear me. Remember when we did this the other day? And I switched to this mic and the callers could hear me? I'm hoping that this makes a difference. Hello, 1, 2, 3, 4. It still doesn't sound right at all, does it? You gonna bring me up? Try it. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Processor needs to be turned, but that's going to be too big of a job. Unless, all right, I can talk. Aaron says he has a saying for the ladies. This is my guest, Mike, by the way. Says women are like roses. Plant your seed correctly, and they bloom forever. Randy's got a 19 Silverado. Justice has a Nissan Versa. Jesse and Jackson 16 V-dub. Scott in Louisiana has a 22 Silverado. Ooh, he's hammered. Joseph's got a 19 STX. And any of you guys are listening to this right now, we're tuning my mic, actually. But go to GiveMeTheVIN.com and load it up if I do not get you to the air. And the automated bid's kind of screwed up right now. So if it surprises you, the guy will be calling right behind it and clean it up. The foreign companies that produce lethal injection chemicals are now refusing to sell them after discovering they're being used for executions. Liberals want to talk about Denmark social services, but they don't want to talk about Barbie Girl. I don't know what that is. A large portion of the Netherlands is only above water due to a plumbing system, so if you miss the toilet there, everyone is screwed. when the Soviets, it still sounds screwed up. It needs gain, doesn't it? Just overall. When the Soviets arrived at Kabul, the government was like, you want to handle this? Be my guest. Today in Ukraine, heavy fighting over random distillation centers. All right. I don't know. I'm just trying to read so he can get a level off of me. Now it's changing a little bit. Talk to JD. We'll have him rolling in the morning. He'll be signing in the same way you did for the phone, just different user. Now it's sounding better, Mike. Sean said your real time of the stream, so it may not be an issue, but having JD click those switches was always the plan when you said it was going to be on an iPad. PGA and Saudi Arabia's LIV are now buddies. Australian bar apologizes. Sweden makes sex a sport. Heavy metal is good for you. Best U.S. cities naked for bike riding. Philly is number one. Average wedding cost is $29,000 for what? Top 10 things folks are good at, but do not. Yeah. It's good enough. It'll get us there.
Now, back to the John Clay Wolf Show. Hit him up right now, 1-800-800-RADIO. This is the John Clay Wolf Show.
And this is where we do the car segment real quick. We bid cars right here on the air for GiveMeTheVIN.com. That's where the bids are good. Let's see. Joe, you there? Joseph, yeah. Can you hear me? Okay. You have a 19 yeah. F1. Hello? Yeah, you have a 19 F-150 F. SXT, is it the, it says six cylinder, is it the turbocharged or the non-turbocharged?
It's an EcoBoost.
Okay, so it's a twin turbo Eco. And that's a 3.3, right? The displacement?
A what?
3.3?
I think so, yes.
Okay, I'm not sure. EcoBoost. Or is it 2.7? No, 3.5 is the EcoBoost. What is it? Is STX, so it's a... These damn trucks have so many variables. Yes. And it's extended cab or crew cab?
Crew cab.
How many miles?
34,000
miles. I think the miles and the money are about the same. I think it's $33,000 truck. It's STX. $30,000 truck.
$30,000?
Yep. Okay. $30,000. Go to GiveMeTheVIN.com, load her up. All right. Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Uh-huh. Randy, you have a truck, a 19 Silverado Chevy half-ton Trail Boss. Z51. For those that don't know, what is the Trail Boss package consist of?
I can barely hear you.
What is the Trail Boss package consist of? What's that mean? I see it. I don't even know.
All right. The Trail Boss, it's a factory lift, a factory Chevrolet lift. the 2-inch lift, four-wheel drive, big tires, big wheels.
Leather or cloth?
It's cloth. Got door-to-door, like the WeatherTech, 100% covers, floor mats, front and rear.
Is it extended cab or crew cab?
It's extended cab. I think it's the smaller doors. It's not the big door like the crew.
Okay. So it's a double cab trail boss.
Double cab. Okay.
Double cab.
That's what I was looking for.
How many miles?
Yeah. Spray-in bed liner. It's got just about 40.
I'm a 32, $33,000 buyer.
That might do it.
All right. Go to give me the VIN dot box. Airborne. What's your comment? Airborne, you're on.
Hello?
Yeah, go.
Hello?
Go. You're on the air.
Oh, good morning, John. Let's catch your show for an hour or so, too, on a Saturday when I can.
Good.
I'm always working. So I have some comedy for you.
You can always grab the podcast after the show and get all 4 hours.
I don't do computers or podcasts or any of that. That's your world, not mine,
sir. Did you do 8-track tapes or cassette tapes?
Oh, yeah, back in the day. Okay. We did 8-track tapes, and then it moved to cassette.
All this is a tape of the show with the commercials and the music stripped out. So just think of it like
a tape. I don't buy computers or do computers. I don't do computers.
Do you have a phone?
I don't touch electronics.
Do you have a phone?
I have a flip phone. I use a Stone Age flip phone.
Oh, wow. I'll be damned.
I'm from the old days, sir. Okay. I'm not a part of this nonsense.
What is your comedy that you want to share with the world?
The joke that he just said about the tiles.
Yeah.
That's really an old joke from the 70s, and it's from the female's position, from a woman's point of view.
Okay.
And it said, hello?
Yeah.
It said, men are like floor tiles. Lay them correctly the first time, and you can walk on them forever.
Ah.
That's from the woman's point of view. I saw that on a t-shirt in 75.
Okay.
Then I came up with a joke. Women are like roses. Plant your seed correctly, and they bloom forever.
And there he is, everybody. It took a minute to get there. 800-800-7234. Remember, you can go to jcwshow.com, click the video link, and it'll show the... We don't charge for it like a lot of these shows do. You can just go right to it, and you can see the audio and video of us in the studio if you want to watch it on television that way or whatever television is these days. I'm confused with what a TV is. Anyway, we'll get all that in a minute. My name's John Clay Wolf. Be right back.
The John Clay Wolf Show.
No one knew where he came from.
But everybody wanted what he was selling.
Check out the podcast.
He was just some hillbilly who got on a plane and then just landed somewhere.
Please beware. The voice in your head is a threat.
JCWShow.com or JohnClayWolf.com.
Picture you getting down in a picture tube, like you lit the fuse. You think it's fictional, mystical, maybe spiritual. Hero who appears in you to clear your view when you're too crazy. Life the definition for what life is. Priceless to you because I put you on the high. Like it, gun smoke, you're righteous with one talk. You're psychic among no possess you with one go.
I'm feeling glad I got sunshine in a bag. I'm useless, but not for long. The future is coming on. Ain't happy. I'm feeling glad I got sunshine in a bag. I'm useless, but not for long. The future is coming on. It's coming on. It's coming on. It's coming on. It's coming on.
The essence, the basics. Without it, you naked. Allow me to make this. Child like your nature, rhythm, you have it or you don't, that's a fallacy, I'm in them. Every sprouting tree, every child of peace, every cloud and sea. You see with your eyes, I see destruction and demise, corruption in the skies, from this enterprise. Now I'm sucked into your lies through rust, so not in muscles, but percussion to provide with me as a guide. Y'all can see me now cause you don't see with your eye, you perceive with your mind, that's the end. So I'ma stick around with rust and be a mentor, bust a few rhymes so motherfuckers remember. But the thought is, I brought all this so you can survive when law is lawless. Right, feeling sensations that you thought was dead. No squealing, remember that it's all in your head.
Ain't happy, I'm feeling glad I got sunshine in a bag. I'm useless, not for long. The future is coming on. Ain't happy, I'm feeling glad I got sunshine in a bag. I'm useless, not for long. My future is coming on. It's coming on. It's coming on. It's coming on. It's coming on. My future is coming on. It's coming on. It's coming on. My future is coming on.
Stand by.
Now return to the John Clay Wolfe Show, America's largest weekend morning show.
It's so big.
Call John, toll free, 800-800-RADIO. And check out the podcast at jcwshow.com or johnclaywolfe.com. Give me the vape. The John Clay Wolfe Show.
Bob, do you have marijuana in that vape pen?
Sir, no sir.
All right, let's check. When you smoke it in and hold it, it makes me wonder.
Yeah, I'm using zero nicotine. I've really got to quit the cigarettes again. How did I get started on that again? You know how?
Because you're worried about a switching studio.
Because all my friends smoke like trains. My son came home from Virginia last October with a package of delicious Camel cigarettes.
Delicious.
Delicious, baby.
Give me one of those, boy.
Delicious.
And here we are.
So the Saudis opened the door to the PGA. They upped the stakes so much in golf with the LIV tour that the PGA finally caved and they joined forces. Now, who was it that left a couple of years ago and got paid huge? And then Mickelson. The PGA said, you cannot play for us anymore. That was Nicholson?
Mickelson.
Yeah. And they announced last week that they're going to combine the two tours. So some of these little ones will go away, like the Colonial could go away.
Good.
Yeah. But the money is times X, times three, times five.
Oh, it's triple, yeah.
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 But what's the big beef? Why the problem? Why is everybody freaking out about it?
Well, the big question is, why did they...
Not allowed to play golf?
When PGA players left to play LIV tournaments, PGA's like, nope, you're out of the PGA. I mean, they took a stand to this thing. You know, it's backed by Saudi Arabia, and there are some human rights concerns going back for years. Yeah, they got that English journalist, they lured him into a hotel somewhere.
When?
A couple of years ago.
Okay.
Khashoggi, I think was his name.
Don't make fun.
And they murdered the guy and cut him into little pieces, and he was seen no more. And that was reportedly sanctioned by the top level of Saudi Arabian government. So there are reasons that some people have trouble with the Saudis, right? JD's got a story about how this was covered on last week's PGA Tour. This came out over the weekend, by the way, via Twitter. So they didn't announce it like big time.
And they're using the word sports washing or using financial funding on professional sports to help improve a group or a nation's image. Yeah, or standing. So Jim Nance and Jay Mohanan had this to say last Sunday about one particular protest that is causing a lot of bad press for the PGA. This is cut number three.
9/11 Families United sent a letter to the representatives of Phil, Dustin, Bryson, Reed, and others, quote, expressing their outrage towards the golfers for participating in the new league and accusing them of sports washing and betraying the United States, end quote.
As it relates to the families of 9/11, I have two families that are close to me that lost loved ones. And so my heart goes out to them. And I would ask, you know, any player that has left or any player that would ever consider leaving, have you ever had to apologize for being a member of the PGA Tour?
Right. That's a pretty good point.
So he's blaming Saudis on 9/11?
Well, Osama bin Laden was a Saudi.
I mean, that's kind of a bit
Jeffrey
of a stretch.
Dahmer was an American.
You know? Monahan was a little more...
Jared from Subway.
Timothy McVeigh
was Colorado.
Yeah.
Timothy McVeigh was an Oklahoman. I think that's a similar. Pretty big reach.
Similar.
To blame. Okay, so if the Saudis were 9/11 and they blew up our buildings, killed all those people, then why the hell are we such good friends with them? Well, just because they have oil?
Yeah, because it wasn't the Saudi Arabian government who did that.
Right.
You know, the instigators of 9/11, the guys who did that, I think most, if not all of them, were Saudis. You know, and I've never heard anything that where people were trying to suggest that the Saudi government had anything to do with it. It's just the water's not quite under the bridge yet, you know, and they're trying to buy their way into what really is a time-honored, prestigious American sports conference.
To make themselves look better.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Pat Robertson died.
He's still dead.
In other news.
Well, did you want to hear him backtrack?
Who, Pat Robertson?
No, not backtrack.
I'd love
Monahan
to hear
that. From that statement, because obviously they said, oh, you know what? Your money's okay, guys. Let's go ahead and take your money. Saudis, let's go. Bring it in.
It's green.
Yeah. Let's hear it.
Yeah.
I recognize everything that I've said in the past in my prior positions. I recognize that people are going to call me a hypocrite. And anytime I've said anything, I said it with the information I had at that moment. And I said it based on someone that's trying to compete for the PGA Tour and our players. And so I accept those criticisms. But circumstances do change. And I think that, you know, in looking at the big picture and looking at it this way, that's what got us to this point.
Cha-ching, baby!
Right.
Circumstances
do change. So what did he accept faster?
Change.
The money or the criticisms?
Oh, the money.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
What's Randy the Chipmunk think about this? He's a big golf
cha-ching,
gambler.
Baby!
Yeah, no kidding. He's got to be...
He bets on everything. I would imagine he's betting on golf as well.
Where is he at? Hold on. He's Randy, come here.
He's getting coffee.
He's walking around. He's lost here. Is he running from a goat?
Yes, yeah, he is. We have goats on the property.
Hey, that's weird. It's weird, y'all out here. At
the ranch, it's
where
weird.
Where are we?
We're at the John Clay Wolfe Ranch.
It's the W6 Ranch.
W6 Ranch.
That's the name of it.
W6
Son
Ranch.
Son of a bitch.
I know. We have goats.
Can you bring them up?
I rode out with Bobbo. This is a scary place. You seen all the animals?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
What do you want me out here for?
Just to get away from people.
You would think you'd want to be out here with the animals and nature.
There's like 40 goats across the road.
Right.
You ever been around a goat?
Yes.
Goats are crazy.
Why?
You ever see Fatal Attraction?
Sure.
Okay, you know that woman falls in love with Michael Douglas?
Right.
Before you know it, she's like boiling his daughter's rabbit in his own house.
Right.
Goats are like that. They love you at first. Then they love you too much. They're like, give me a hug.
Well, Randy, you'll be happy to know that these goats are Persian Ibex goats, and you raise them and you sell them for about $4,000 a piece when they're 3-4 years old.
Wow. Don't matter. They're
and
crazy.
Then, but you know how their life ends? On a game ranch, and they get shot.
They don't kill
them.
Oh,
boy. Well, that's good.
Don't say that.
At least you know what to do with them. But you know, you go up to hug the goat. You go up to give him a hug. I don't know what he wants. This guy likes me. I'm going to give him a damn hug, right? You get up close to him. He puts his horn down. He's like.
So your goats that we're looking at and loving on are going to
be. When I bought this place, this enclosure of this goat operation was already here.
Right.
And I kept it, and the kids feed them and pay for their feed and their vet bills and all that. It's their business. So when they're about 4 years old, they have these great big horns, and you sell them to game hunting ranches for about $4,000, and then they sell them to hunters for about $6,000 or $8,000. That's what they charge hunters to hunt them.
And they kill them?
They kill them dead.
Release them.
And then the hunters take them to the taxidermist and make a mount of them and put them on their wall. And they pay the game ranchers about $10,000 to do it.
Well, they need more supervision because there's one of them out there they call Blue Jay. Yep. It's selling raw opium.
And that's what we might do with you when we're done with you, Randy.
I don't think that's happening.
Is send you to the taxidermist and put you on the wall.
That's a good idea. I like taxidermists.
800-800-7234. 800-800-RADIO.
We have a fun news blooper. We love news bloopers. This one we picked up from Action 7 News in Albuquerque. It's an anchor previewing an upcoming interview with a mountain climber, not a goat, but a mountain climber, who has achieved an amazing feat, despite the fact that he has a handicap. With an unfortunate slip of the tongue, it turned into a blooper. Cut number 5.
We're going to interview Eric Weihenmayer, who climbed the highest mountain in the world, Mount Everest. But he's gay. I mean, he's gay. Excuse me. He's blind. So we'll hear about that coming up.
And we'll hear about that right after this commercial. Musical break right here on the John Clay Wolfe Show. Good morning, West Coast. This is y'all's first hour. Good morning, L.A., KGB in San Diego, Tucson, Vegas, Phoenix, Sac. Hey, be right back.
Hi, this is Gigi with the John Clay Wolfe Radio Show, brought to you by GiveMeTheVIN.com. GiveMeTheVIN.com will give you top dollar for your vehicle and pick it up. No hassles, no worries. Our Google reviews tell the story of happy customers coast to coast. Ready to sell your car? Go to GiveMeTheVIN.com. That's GiveMeTheVIN.com.
Sell us your car. GiveMeTheVIN.com. So easy you can do it.
Listening to the most popular Saturday morning show to ever broadcast in America. You're listening to the John Clay Wolfe Show. Feel free to call and make your voice heard. 800-800-RADIO. If you missed any of the show, go to jcwshow.com right now and download the podcast, The John Clay Wolfe Show.
30 seconds. Stand by.
Passes bill to discuss Greater Idaho border relocation.
Huh?
Right.
In English, please.
You haven't heard this since the Louisiana Purchase or the Santa Ana, the Alamo stuff, and Texas started moving their borders around.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, in 2020, Oregon became the first state to decriminalize hard drugs, and now they're paying people to be homeless and use hard drugs.
What?
And 90% of the state is disgusted by it, and they want to leave and join Idaho.
Oh, they want to leave Oregon.
Oregon counties vote to secede. You know, we're always talking about seceding, and you hear Texas talking about seceding.
Yeah.
From the Union. Or no, this is dude, this thing's getting traction.
This is real. Yeah, they're really doing it.
So they're seceding from Oregon,
and they're joining Idaho. Huh.
Because it's more conservative.
Why don't they just move over there?
Well, why don't
they're already
just
there.
Get rid of the drugs?
They're just saying, let's move the fence.
Huh.
We don't believe in Portland, the craze, the coastal, the liberal side, right?
Sure. Yeah.
They're disgusted, the rest of the state, and they want to leave, and they want to move the fence.
Right. We don't
want to
move
Idaho.
A house. We want to move
the line. Okay. We want to be Idaho and not Oregon.
As a state, they want to do this.
Correct.
Well, it's a free country. Let's put her to a vote, fellas.
That's what they're doing. That's and the vote passed.
There you go.
Now, it's first level pass.
Yeah.
And the more liberal, I don't know if it's the House or
the senators are saying, this is funny, but it's never going to pass.
Why not?
Because they don't want to lose the tax money.
They don't want to lose the tax money.
Dude, if you look at the map, I mean, it's like 80% of Oregon would leave Oregon. And
what's
go
left
to
over? Portland and
just the coast. They want to give up their coast.
Is there a lot of tax money there?
Well, on the coast, there's plenty of tax. Oh, is there a lot of tax money in rural Oregon? No.
I mean, no, on the coast. And were there?
Of course.
Sure.
Well, let Oregon go. Would get to keep it.
Let him go.
Let him go. Let him go.
Let him go.
Oregon wants to become a part of Idaho. That's like a hipster realizing they want the whole organic farm to table. It's like they're taking the whole thing too far. I don't know. It's. I hope it happens. It'd be fun.
That's a great song.
Oregon wants to become part of Idaho. That's like a hipster realizing they've taken the whole organic farm-to-table thing a bit too far. You know what? Forget kale smoothies and vegan quinoa bowls. Let's just embrace potatoes and country music. I can already see Oregonians showing up in Idaho with their man buns, asking where the nearest yoga studio is. While the Idaho folks scratch their heads and think, son, we don't do downward dog here. We cowboy up. It's going to be a clash of cultures. Buckle up. Huh. Ask my son to start writing me some jokes, and he wrote that.
That's a good one.
It's all right.
Yeah, that's all right, man.
That's good.
So if you hear me say something smart, it came from my kid. 800-800-7234, 800-800-RADIO. It's time for You Just Lost a Listener, guys.
We can do that.
Remember, the video stream's up at jcwshow.com. Click the button, and it'll do audio and video now.
You just lost a listener.
Well, this one comes from Marilyn Cratchit. I cannot believe this is to you, John, how irresponsible you are. You've got so many kids, and now you're out there acting like a 90s dirt bike movie star trying to be Billy Badass. Cut it out. Your old bones are soft and fragile. Why not curl up with hot tea and a nice book like an adult? Can't imagine the strife you're putting your wife through.
Oh, she's talking about me wrecking my motorcycle.
Wrecking the bike, you know, and breaking your collarbone and a couple of ribs.
And I'm realizing separating my shoulder, and I did crack 4 ribs.
My goodness, I cannot stand your dangerous stories anymore. Grow up. and get your jet ski. It's hard to kill yourself when you're crashing into water. You silly, silly man. Marilyn
Sounds
Cratchit.
Just like my dad.
You just lost a
When I was in...
Marilyn Cratchit?
Cratchit, right?
Sixth grade, I was racing 80s. And then I got a 125, which is a full-size bike. Mm-hmm. My dad would never go to the races. He'd drop me off, leave, and come back. And that day, he came when I was going to race the 125 the first time in sixth grade. I had to stand on a milk crate to hold it up in the starting line. Yeah. Gate drops. I pulled the whole shot, win the moto. Because in those motocross races, you do two motos, and they take the average of the two. And, you know, when I got done, so I'm in sixth grade, riding in the big boy class, and I win it in intermediate.
Awesome.
And my dad said, well, that's great. You look great.
Yeah.
Let's put it up.
Put it up.
Yeah. And what? I was like, there's another moto. We have another race this afternoon. I said, that's the first one.
Right.
He's like, no, there's not another moto. You're done. You're going too fast. You're going to get hurt. So he made me stop racing. Stop. And he got me jet skis.
Oh.
And I started racing jet skis.
Sure.
Kawasaki 550 modified expert class. You've never been hit until you've been run over by a jet ski going 40 miles an hour.
Yeah.
When they're coming at you, you wear a helmet and you have your life jacket and you stick your head under the water so you just hit your back. Just knocks the wind right out of your ass. So I'll do it. She wants me to start riding jet skis.
People get killed every year in jet skis, yes.
Yeah.
Hitting the water at 40 is like hitting cement.
I'm going to start riding. I'm going to be riding again as soon as I can get. I think, this happened 2 weeks ago, and the surgery was a week ago, so I've got 6 weeks.
And you don't have your sling on today.
I don't. I talked to the doctor about it. He said your collarbone is so titaniumed up that it's not moving at all.
How many?
Ten screws.
Ten screws.
And a bunch of plate. And he said the sling is really to keep the incision from breaking open. So if you notice, I'm keeping my elbow down.
Right.
I'm doing it right. He said the sling was. He said you don't. The sling's not for your collarbone anymore. He said it's just to keep. He doesn't want that big cut to open up.
Sure.
So you got to be careful with it. And it's healing.
It's beautiful, man. You put on pictures of the structure, the operation. It looks like Japanese architecture. It's beautiful.
It's beautiful. Dr. George Liebus. He did a nice job.
It's beautiful.
Look, he's showing us the.
Yeah,
thing.
I'm showing your scar. You gonna see my boob job next?
You can see it on camera if you go to jcwshow.com and click the video link. You can see his and you
Gigi,
also see.
Gigi, enough about me. And back to the boobs. Have you ever thought about getting a boob job?
I would like to have one, and I am willing to subject myself to one if anyone wants to pay for it.
Well, this is easy. I mean, we're on all over the country. Plastic surgeon guy wants a plug. Yes. Give Gigi some boobs.
Yes, yes. Make them symmetrical and perky. You know what I mean?
What size would you go?
Well, I have one side that's a double D already, so I just like them to match.
So you just need one boob job?
I just need like a half a boob, like a half an implant to kind of make a match and then do some extra work to kind of perk them up a little bit.
Was it always that way or did one just lose a little?
Yes, it's always been a whole cup size smaller on the left than on the right. So like a long time ago, you know, when like the bustiers were popular and stuff like that to where I could never do that because one was like if it was the right size over here. Uh-huh. Then over here, it was just lost.
What can you?
Like, what happened?
If you really want to get some video streamers,
here we go.
If you'll pull them out,
yeah,
and
see,
we can show
me your boobs.
Look at. Well, but look
that's
at my tan
line.
Do you see my tan line? Yeah, okay. I'll be your brown baby. Okay.
So.
That's right.
How do you buy bras if one cup size is different?
Well, you have a choice to make. You can have like. You can have this extra breast right here, which gives a little cleavage.
Right.
And
this tight.
Yeah, because you need support,
okay.
Right?
So the right one's the big one?
The right one. This one is the big one.
At jcwshow.com, click video.
And this one is a whole cup size smaller. So because this one is overflowing, this means this cup size fits.
That's an
For
art.
Anyone who's having trouble buying bras, there you have it.
So when you wear a strapless dress at a formal or something growing up, what did you do? Did you have to stuff one to make them match?
Yeah, well, you know what? My daughter taught me.
No, I don't.
So you roll up a sock, right? I was trying to see if I could like.
JD's been doing that for years.
Years, man.
No. But you roll it up like this, and then you put it underneath your breast, so it lifts it up, and it gives you some cleavage. Okay.
Oh, I'm serious. I mean, this is easy. Doctors,
you think so?
Doctors that want free publicity, fix Gigi's boob.
But what area?
Well, don't stop at my boob.
She's in California.
Well, I know that's a big state.
Yeah, California.
Do it all.
She lives in Temecula. I think that's the one thing she would drive to L.A. for. I mean, you've been to that L.A. clap doctor years ago.
What?
I'm kidding.
Did you guys hear about the bar in Australia?
You know, anyways, Bobbo and JD.
You see what the video stream's saying? She said they're saying at the John Clay Wolf show.
What?
Get some duct tape, Gigi. Just put some duct tape.
Well, you
on
know
there.
They do have boob tape where you can. But I don't want that. I want to know what it feels like to have perky, symmetrical breast.
All right.
That's not too much, right?
Do you want the left one? Do you want? Would you want the whole thing bigger, or do you just want the one to match?
Oh, I never thought about that. I think this is a pretty good size.
Well, I can't see. It's cutting off in the camera. Just pick up a little bit.
See, I think this is a pretty... Let me see.
Oh, yeah, I mean, that's
I think this is a pretty good size. It just needs to match. This one is smaller, and if you look at it, right, you see this, right?
Right.
But then you see this, right?
So you got a handful and then a handful and a half.
Okay.
Yeah.
Look at our video hits just went through the roof.
So you want the handful to match the handful
look,
and a half.
You can tell. Look it. You can tell, right? This is the big one,
right?
And this is the small one. And see, there's that slant.
Right.
Yes, it is a slant.
You see it?
There is a slant.
You see it? It's like, woo.
It's not square. Right? It's not perpendicular. It's
no,
not a
this one needs to be bigger, and this one's okay.
We're going to solve that problem and more when we come back.
Thank you.
After this musical break and a quick commercial on the John Clay Wolf Show. Brought to you by America's Best Car Buyer. Give me the VIN. Give me the VIN. Give me the VIN. Give me the VIN.com. And if we lose you, we're fixing to lose a couple people right now. Go to the stream at jcwshow.com because of the time zone shift.
Tonight there's gonna be trouble. Some of us won't survive.
The John Clay Wolf Show is heard every week on great stations like 93.7 KLBJ, The Rock of Austin, and 107.9 in Colorado Springs. KBPL rocks the Rockies. Stream us live online or pick up the country's fastest growing podcast at jcwshow.com and at johnclaywolf.com. And we'll be back with more of the John Clay Wolf Show right after this. Pretty good looking woman about my age, okay? I'm saying late 40s, early 50s, walking around the supermarket, and this was the good supermarket, with an upside down pineapple in the kid carrier part of her shopping cart. She was all alone. What does that mean?
That means that her man sent her to the grocery store to find another couple, I think.
Damn. That means you had a chance.
See, nobody's looking for a single fella anymore.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody's looking for what? Single? No.
Why didn't you ask her what it meant?
Yeah. What's that mean, girly?
I was intimidated.
Of what?
Well, I mean, she had the pineapple, obviously. So, you know, you always, a guy like me, like, listen, I'm adventurous.
Did she look pretty square, like maybe she made a mistake?
No, she looked pretty up for it.
Did she have any tats?
Yeah.
Heels?
No, she had really, really pretty little open sandals.
Open shoes, though. Yeah.
Is that a thing?
I mean, it's kind of a thing. It's not a thing.
Eye contact, too. If she's looking around instead of looking just at fruit, then if she's looking around, she's shopping for you.
She may have been. She saw me looking. She had like a tight, mini shorts, but not slutty. And kind of a flowing white
like a Prince shirt, you know, the kind of white French shirt that Prince would wear.
What you doing this for with your fingers? Like what are you
white
thinking
flowing,
about?
White flowing, a white flowing shirt.
You trying to get your
nippies
hard?
Did you see the
Prince? Yeah, see, look at him, look at him. He's like, she had a flowing.
When Doves Cry video, like Prince has got a white flowing French, what do they call shirts over there? She had a blouse.
It was blouse versus skins.
Beautiful.
In the Dave Chappelle skit where they're playing basketball.
Long, straight Rachel from Friends, blonde hair, but dark eyebrows. She was all about it, and I was intimidated.
All right. Next time, you'll have another chance. Backtracks. Cut one, Tom Petty. Cut two. Angelica in California, you there?
Hello?
Yeah, what are your two guesses?
I think the first one is Here Comes My Girl, and the second one is Learning to Fly.
The first one is correct. Hudson in Florida.
Yeah.
What's your guesses? What are your guesses?
Here Comes My Girl, track one, and Running Down a Dream.
Crab in Southern California. No, that's wrong.
I can't hear the other callers, but Gigi, I got $20 for your boob fund.
Right on. Bring it on.
$20.
Bring well, it on. Got to start
we're
from somewhere.
Sweetheart, so I got American Girl and It's Good to Be King and John.
Yep.
How'd you end up with the KLS microphone, dude?
Because I work there and they gave it to me. To bring back to the studio.
Oh, I thought Heidi and Frank may have given it to you because she liked it so much or something. But
no.
Have a good day, buddy.
Thank you. David in Florida.
Hey. How's it going, John Clay Wolf?
Good, sir. Yes, sir. Colonel, sir.
Yep, I have Here Comes My Girl and You Wrecked Me.
Yeah. Ding, 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 ding. There you go. Dave, what city are you in?
In Jacksonville, about 50 miles away from Gainesville, where Tom Petty hails from.
Yeah. All right. Makes sense. Pre-K, I'm going to put him on hold line three, grab David, and send him his stuff.
By the way, love the show, love everything y'all do, and Gigi, you are hot.
Ooh, thank you.
That's David in Jacksonville, Florida. 800-800-7234, 800-800-RADIO. When we come back, we're going to do the car segment where I'll bid the cars on the air. Give me year, make, model, miles. We're clearing the phone lines. You can get in. Year, make, model, miles, average, rough, or clean. Corvettes, Jeeps, heavy cars. You know what I'm going to do? Grab that pink Rolls, the pimp one, that we sold this week at auction. We had a pink Rolls Royce. It's black sides.
Right, two-tone.
Hot pink top. A Wraith. The big two-door. And it was hard to get people bidding on it. But once they realized what I was saying was correct, they figured they could sell it. Let's go.
If you ever thought you wanted to change career,
They only brought 120 grand, is that right?
Yeah.
God, I thought that car did more than that. I mean, it's a bad ass. Obviously, nobody from Miami. If you're a car dealer and you want to buy badass merch, go to the Give Me the Vin Lanes in Manheim, Dallas on Wednesday morning.
Like that car, in the Dick Tracy movie, man.
Some retailer's going to make 40 grand on that. Gave it away. Gave it away. I lost 10,000 on the damn thing. 800-800-7234, 800-800-RADIO. Pimpin' ain't easy, but we try. We'll be right back.
Heard on the air every Saturday morning.
From New York to Los Angeles to Houston and broadcasting to the rest of the world online at jcwshow.com or johnclaywolf.com. You're listening to The John Clay Wolf Show. Want more of The John Clay Wolf Show? Check out the largest radio show and fastest growing podcast at jcwshow.com.
Callers, hang tight. Make sure you're off Bluetooth and radios are down. Hang tight. We'll be back here in about 2 minutes. One minute, callers, make sure you're off Bluetooth and radio's down. 1 minute. Stand by.
Now, back to the John Clay Wolfe Show.
You probably think that you are better. You know why we played this song while you're making faces at me, you little bitch?
Pardon me?
I mean, I saw those looks.
Come over here and say that.
You and those looks, Jesus Christ. I mean,
what look?
Oh, just crappy looks. Just always giving me bad looks. I made a decision to play Post Malone on this intro for a reason.
But that's what that is.
Yeah, that's what that is.
I was looking like, what is that?
Because this is the car segment, right? So why would you play Post Malone? Because we bought Post Malone's Cadillac Escalade last week.
Oh, yeah, 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 yeah.
And I just posted a picture of it, no pun intended, on the John Clay Wolfe Show Facebook page. And it's pretty funky.
It was a wild thing. It's black with, like, is yellow that his signature stripes? In yellow?
I don't know. It's ugly as hell is what it is, but...
Pretty out there.
And it really didn't even bring as much money as a normal one because it was so gummed up from his the graphics on it. But it was Post Malone's Escalade on the front of the title. It said Post Motorsports. Or he has some company that he keeps his cars in. But anyway.
It's like, so, him. It's all tatted up. Just too much.
Yeah.
Way too much.
Who all have we bought cars from? Beyonce, Post Malone.
Couple athletes.
Lenny Kravitz. We bought his blue Ferrari last year.
Was it Albert Pujols, I think? Was the baseball
and the
player?
The football player guy.
Yeah. Oh, we bought a ton of athletes. Ton of athletes.
Beyonce?
Beyonce was probably my personal fave.
Was there a...
There's more.
Little country girl's baby sister
oh,
singer.
Oh, yeah. Britney Spears' baby sister. She went into the location in Louisiana and sold us a Rover. Anyway. Yeah. Celebrities do it all the time. We need to have a montage of that, actually. Jimmy, you have it. 18 F-250. We're really jumping gears from super celebrities to Jimmy and his 18 Ford F-250.
Huh.
Not leather, but cloth. Leather. Jimmy, can you hear me?
I hear you.
Okay. 70,000 miles on your diesel Ford truck. Are you a Post Malone fan?
Not really.
I didn't figure. That's all good. It's low 30s. How much is it?
I don't have a price in mind.
I'm 32,000 is what my gut's telling me. It's a cloth one, right?
Yes, sir.
Is it long bed or short?
Long bed.
Yeah.
Four-wheel drive.
32, maybe 33,000.
Okay.
Go to GiveMeTheVin.com, load it up, we'll buy it. Brad, speaking of trucks, what do you have? Brad in Kansas City!
Hey.
You want 40, no, you want 58,000 for your Dodge, right?
Yes.
Okay, here's the problem. Dodge started making cars, and you can buy that truck. You need to look at sticker. These Dodges, Chrysler Jeeps, are way down. I mean, they're doing incentivized rates now. They're making discounts. They're doing rebates. The crazy number on the Dodge Chrysler Jeep platform is over. And I think you're 10. I don't think I know. You're 10,000 too high.
I'm sorry. I can't hear you. What'd you say?
It's too high. It's 10,000 too high. We'll give 46 grand. Name's John Clay Wolfe. Be right back.
Yeah, some people say syndicated shows aren't that good because they don't have that local feel.
Right.
But you don't skyrocket to the number one weekend spot by sucking. The largest radio show and fastest growing podcast, The John Clay Wolfe Show. Go to jcwshow.com.
I need to read. Well, now it sounds pretty good. Now, so Bobbo, talking to yours. No, oh, turn. Can you turn Bobbo on so we can get the level? So Bob, let's just talk back and forth and see, okay. And he can play. Okay. So and JD, if you hear differences, let us know. So when you're talking about Larry, when you're doing who? See, I'm splashy right now. Okay, I'm gonna take me down a bit. So, JD,
you need to use a little more nuance on your microphone, Larry.
You need to use a little. See, I'm splashy now too. Do you hear splash, JD? All right. Yeah, it's something's wrong. Listening now and caught the tail end about terrorists. Would you consider a serial killer a terrorist? How about the Old West and people like Billy the Kid, the original Billy the Kid? Look who was Marshal of Austin, Texas, 1881. Yes, I would consider Ben to be a serial killer. And now it's sounding better, Mike.
All right.
For sure. But Bob's still so much brighter and
I haven't
wider.
My deal, but he may have my level up somewhere.
It's not that you're too loud. It's that you're tuned properly.
It does not sound good, Larry.
It's sounding real good. Yours is sounding real good.
That's because you know what you got to do before
what?
You talk to the migrant. You need to cock your neck up.
Cock your neck up?
Cock it up.
All right.
Cock it up.
All right.
Cock your neck up. Like, and then just remember how good looking you think you is and talk like that. Like, this is John Clay Wolf.
Yeah.
Let me tell you about my bitch. My bitch doing the puzzles on the waffle spot.
Did I tell you when I went by
so
Larry?
I ran the bitch off.
Did I tell you when I went by Larry David's house?
Yeah.
Yeah, and I asked his maid. She was out front. I was like, is this where Larry David's
one
lives?
Minute.
She's like, yeah. It still didn't, yeah.
Did you talk to Leon?
I did not talk to Leon. I was looking for Leon. What's his name?
That guy's hilarious. JB Smoove.
We need him on the show, dude. I love that guy.
Yeah, okay.
Check on his publicist, whoever it is. But JB Smoove is more than welcome here. I heard him on another show somewhere. He's funny as hell.
He's doing the commercials for Caesar's Palace Sports Betting online.
Okay.
He's like the Caesar.
Right. Oh, I've got me blasted up. Oh.
You get reward from Caesar.
Okay. So but this should just be level, right? I mean, this is not tuning. No, that's, but it's splashy. Okay. But it's getting better. Huh. All right. But it's all over the red on my board, too.
Sounded fine.
Am I all over? Are your needles all red, Turley, when I'm talking? Yeah.
But it doesn't.
It doesn't. I don't know. How much time we got?
We got to come back.
All right.
From the Wolf Radio Studios, it's time for the John Clay Wolf Show. Call John, toll free, cheap bastards, 1-800-800-RADIO. Now, John Clay Wolf.
One of his best songs. Rest in peace, Chris Cornell. Good morning, Saturday morning. It's a beautiful Saturday summer morning. If you don't want any traffic, drive up and down the PCH. I'm sure there's nothing there. I have a friend that lives over there. He said, I just do not get on it during the summertime. Yeah, but a weekend like this. Gigi, how's the weather out there? I'm talking like California's beautiful today.
Yeah, it's gray. Yeah. It's got a bad case of June gloom. I think the sun was out for maybe 3 hours yesterday.
Yeah?
So, yeah, it's gray.
Are you
but
guys
it's still California, so it's great.
You can name the smoke from Canada?
No, not down there.
No, not there. Okay.
No, they get their smoke from Hawaii, man.
They get their smoke from Oregon, dog.
See what you did.
They get their smoke from the LIV, the PGA, and Saudi Arabia's LIV golf are now buddies that we discussed earlier. Australian bar apologizes. Free drinks for ladies based on their bra size. This goes along with Gigi.
Ooh, we're talking about Gigi's bra size.
Okay, I'm
sold.
I would get more drinks for this side.
Well,
than this side,
this
right?
This bar actually got in trouble and they're apologizing now. They had a big advertisement saying the larger your bra size, the more drinks you get for free. Basically, one free drink for an A cup, two for a B, and so on. Three for a C, but then everybody jumped on them and they had to go away and they had to say, sorry, we're sorry, it's not misogynistic at all. We're just trying to sell beer.
Heavy metal is good for you, psychologist says. It lessens stress and makes you more focused.
Clinical psychologist says heavy metal is good for you because it lessens stress and allows for emotional release. Metalheads also tend to be more logical and focused and can process their anger. That I believe.
Huh.
What's the next one?
Let's see here. About
best U.S. cities for naked bike riding.
LawnStarter.com recently conducted a survey to determine the American cities that are best for naked bike riding, and you're really not going to like the top cities. You think it'd be maybe somewhere in Florida, maybe where people are tan and maybe, well, they're kind of retired there too, but actually the top three are Philadelphia, Portland, Oregon, and Seattle.
Oh,
I know, right?
Two hairy, hairy beasts in the cities.
Yeah, where they never get any sunlight.
Are you twitching over there? Are you okay?
No. Sweden registered sex as a sport, and they're going to host the first ever sex championship, including these will be some of the events: seduction, massage, and the act.
So, all right.
How is it graded? Like, how are they going to do this?
That's a good question. Participants will be judged on creativity, strong emotion, imagination, physical fitness, endurance, and workability.
That's why we do the thing with the bat.
There's the Aussie.
Well, bring more ladies into the bat. Ever since the COVID, which we didn't have as bad as you, Bobs, by the way.
Right.
Bringing ladies back to the bar. Here's what we do. Take a look at your brassiere size. Right? We gave away a lot of Fosters. Fosters sponsored our little brassiere promotion. Right. Until a lot of little ladies, and I do mean little, didn't like the idea because they said we were misogynist.
Right.
And I'm misogynist is what you are.
Misogynist. And I don't even know what that means. Right? I mean, I'm obviously in Australia.
What do you think about these Swedes doing competitive sex?
I think they should. I've made a little commercial that we use or they could use if it translates to the Swedish.
And Swedish.
The Swedish are very picky about their vocal announcements on the commercial, right?
Okay.
It starts like this. They say something very alluring like, "Hey, baby, want to go see the land down under?" Which always brings them in, you know, right? You've heard of casual sex. Now get ready for competitive sex. We're going to start with your brassieres and get all the way down to your knickers before we're done. Right?
Right.
Get them down into the shorty shorts, and we'll give away more than drinks for that. Or I will, anyway. And we've got bicycle riding. We're also seeing a rise in nude unicycling, which is very dangerous. Very dangerous.
Yeah.
I bet.
It's all to stay on, anyway. But if you fall off a unicycle naked, you're going to feel that in the bejeebies, right? I said it, bejeebies.
Competitive sex, how do you do that?
Well, like I said, they have massage.
So it's just going to be porn? It's going to be like the...
And then the judges, there's a panel of judges, they vote who's the best at massage.
And it's brought to you by Bang Brothers? I mean, that's what it
sounds like. Didn't say that, no. And then they also have
Or Brazzers?
An audience gets to vote as well.
Leave it to those damn Swedes.
I know. They just have the best.
Musical interludes by ABBA.
It's so big.
They got the hot ladies. They got everything going for them.
800-800-7234-800-800-RADIO. I still don't understand why the golf thing is such a big deal.
Because they went so long hating the Saudis for, what do they call it, sports washing, Mike?
Right. Well, they also hated him for stealing some of their athletes.
Yes.
Correct.
Yeah. Mickelson cost the PGA a little money when he wasn't there to watch on Sundays. Right?
Right.
Yeah. But the majors is where the PGA makes all their money.
Sure.
And it was just the small tournaments that were losing it. And then so, you know, you have to basically, the reason is they're left is because of the small purses in those small tournaments where the Saudis like, hey, we'll give you $10 million if you win, where like a small tournament in Fort Worth, Texas gives you like $1.5 million.
Right, but that's why we call it a league. It's just like NATO. They're all together, you know, PGA's all together. And they've changed their tune about it, but, you know, that's professional sports.
And now these guys like Rory and Tiger who were loyal, everybody's like, man, don't they feel like they got stabbed in the back? But they're talking about how they're going to have sharing profits with the new PGA that's coming out.
Okay.
So they're going to get paid.
Tiger would not play that Fort Worth one for a long time because they didn't have any black club members, right?
Yeah, that is true.
I think that's great.
Yeah, he took a stand there. And also that course is a little bit difficult for him to navigate. That was part of it also.
Was it? Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's
But you know, this with this new tournament, I guess the new league itself, they're going to make a lot of money off of these athletes, where before, like the lower rung ones, they weren't making much.
Yeah.
So now they're going to actually, it's benefiting the lower rung athletes.
You know, I don't want to use any names because he wouldn't appreciate me bringing up his name, but a good friend of mine, speaking about being out here in the country, you know, we're deep in the country out here in Central Texas, and I never can get him to come out and come fishing and hanging out anymore. He's an old guy. And I talked to him about it the other day. I was like, why don't you come out this weekend after the show? We'll go fishing. He said, I ain't coming out there. You know why? I said, you haven't been out here in a year. He said, you know why I don't come out there, Joe? I was in the store out there, a couple of towns over, getting some smokes. And I heard these guys in the back saying, what's that inn doing in this city?
Oh, yeah.
Get out of here.
I know it.
What? Are you being serious?
I'm being serious as
I'm
I can be.
I'm not surprised.
You're not.
Yeah. Small towns can tend to lean that way sometimes. I mean, you know.
Yeah. I mean, like.
Not just small towns. Big towns, too.
A little louder on G. Yeah, that just really bothered me. And he said, no, I don't want you to get me and, you know, walk me around and force this. He said, because then they'll start causing you problems. He said, I don't want to cause you any problems. I said, you're not going to cause me any problems. And you are welcome out here, and I want you to come out here. And I said, if that store's that way, that just don't stop at that store. He said, it's not just that store. He said, that racism is still heavier than you think. I'm a little blind to it. I just couldn't believe that. It broke my heart to hear that.
Yeah.
I can't,
do you ever catch any of that anymore?
Oh, yeah. I mean, I sit around places where people look at me and they don't want to take me seriously. You know what I mean? So I just sit back. Yeah, but yeah, it happens. It definitely happens. It is not over.
Do you ever see it happening to your kids? Like when you were taking them to sports and this and that?
I didn't really see it sports-wise. You know what I mean? But but one of my daughter's teachers made all kinds of assumptions. And he was funny, but he wasn't trying to be offensive, but he was. He was just like, you probably had to take the bus a long way to get here. My daughter's like, no.
Oh.
You know what I mean? So
like they bust you in?
Huh?
Like they bust you in?
Like she had to take the bus a long way to get here. And he had all these assumptions that he made. Some were true. She, you know, there was no dad in the home, but everything else was not true, but he didn't know it. And he had such a kind, caring heart. It was hard to be mad at him for his assumptions. So.
That's the positive side of what they're calling woke these days, though. Sometimes you can go too far, you know, trying to make up for lost time on issues like that. So, you know, you weren't mad at the guy. You're just like, yeah, this is crazy.
I mean, we had a black president, guys.
Right.
I mean,
our president was black for 8 years.
I mean, he's still black. He was black before then. He was still black before that. I'm assuming. You know what I mean?
Well, for 8 years, he was black.
Well, I meant the president in that seat was a black man for 8 years.
Yes, thank you.
I mean, at that point, I would think that you kind of win.
No, you don't win, because what it did was it brought out
a
level of hatred that has been there, but people have denied, and they couldn't deny it anymore. I mean, I 100% love what it represents, that anybody can be president, but, you know, we're still dealing with the aftermath of the hatred that brought out. It was already there. It just brought it to the surface.
Will you take us out, speaking of going out?
I can definitely do that. But before I do that, I want to say congratulations to my daughter because she graduated from high school.
There you go.
And we'll be right back. Thank you. We'll be right back with more of the John Clay Wolfe Show, brought to you by America's best car buyer, GimmeTheVin.com.
This is Give Me The Vin, the John Clay Wolfe Show.
Get a haircut, buttercup.
America's largest weekend morning show, 800-800-RADIO. Check out the podcast at jcwshow.com or johnclaywolf.com. Hey, the largest radio show and fastest growing podcast, The John Clay Wolfe Show.
You can go ahead and play with it.
Okay, so there's another button that I can... There's... So that button's all the way over.
Okay.
And then there's this button that's next to it. I don't know what it is. That's all the way over. But then the third button in from the left is not all the way over. I can...
Try to play with that and talk.
Turn that. Does that make a difference? Do you hear a difference now?
No.
Okay, because I'm turning it. What about this one?
I don't know. You got to talk.
Oh, sorry. What about this one? Does that make a difference?
No.
Okay, the one before my headphones, does that make a difference? Does this make a difference?
No.
It's not making a difference? Because this one over here, all the way to the left, is turned all the way over. And then here's this one up in the top left. Does this make a difference? Ooh, that just sounds like static.
Yeah, just make sure you put them back where you found them.
Now you tell me. Okay. Okay, so I'm putting them back where I found them, but it still doesn't sound right?
It's not doing anything.
Oh, that's weird. I wonder how come.
Yeah, just eat the mic and speak up.
Okay. I just put my mouth on it like this. Is this good? Is this better if my mouth is this close to it?
Yeah, I mean, it's just not changing the levels, not moving at all.
That's so weird. I'm not doing anything. Okay.
What about your headphones?
Turn my headphones down?
Yeah, so that way you can speak up louder.
Okay, how's this?
Well, now just talk.
Okay, well, I turn my headphones down. Do I sound different?
You sound lighter, actually.
No, I need to sound heavier. But I'm not sure, so I'm turning buttons and... Okay, so now I've turned this button. Do I sound the same?
Yeah, sound different.
I still sound the same?
Yeah.
That's a damn shame. I haven't touched any of the other buttons. None of the other buttons light up anyway, so I don't think they matter. Let me see. What about this one? Did it make a difference?
Mm-mm.
I still sound light?
It's just no different. Just the same. It sounds like it's all flat all the way across. Like it's almost like the board's not even doing anything.
That's weird.
All right, we'll have the video. We got a minute here.
Okay.
One minute.
Return to the John Clay Wolfe Show, America's largest weekend morning show. Call John, toll free, 800-800-RADIO. This is the John Clay Wolfe Show.
Americans experienced more financial loss through scams last year than ever.
I believe it.
Yeah, you know, my daughter, you know, she's an aspiring actress, and she's always going to these sites and applying for acting positions, and she was actually on a role, anyway, she was on a movie set last week, got paid a little bit finally, and did get a line in an A-cut movie. I forgot, Phoebe something, not Phoebe Cates, I'm so old. Whoever the Phoebe is that's famous right now, she was her stand-in. But she did such a good job, they gave her... Anyway, that aside, something I wanted to let you guys know. These phishing scams, when you see insurance companies or banks email you, look at the reply to email address. So if it's fedexhelp.com, right? Like I had one the other day coming from FedEx. They wanted to validate my account.
Oh.
And it says from FedEx, Federal Express, and Dear John, and blah, 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 blah. And then I looked at the reply to email, and it's fedexhelp.com. That's not a real... So then what you do is you take everything after the at sign on the email address, and then go www.fedexhelp.com, and you can see if it's a real FedEx site.
Yeah.
Same thing with bank, like bank1customer75.com. If that's their email address, go to bank1customer75.com and see what the website looks like. And that will help you sniff out the fakes, because I'm so busy. A lot of times I just fire him to Rob, my IT guy, and he's like, fake, 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 fake. It happens all the time. I mean, your parents. I mean,
to everybody.
If you were 80 years old,
yep,
it'd be so damn easy. Have you ever had a financial crimes hit you?
Nope. Haven't had it yet. I've had my checks stolen, but that's before cyber crime.
Right. I just wonder what the banks lose. Because a lot of times they're so good about paying you back.
Sure.
When you have credit card fraud?
Well, they have insurance, you know.
Yeah, but I mean, what's that cost?
What's that cost, yeah.
Jesus Christ. You know, $3,000 racked up in your credit card bill and they put the money back in your account?
Yeah.
Where did that money come from? Insurance? I don't think they have insurance.
I don't think it's FDIC, but they got to have some kind of, you know, unauthorized charges, you know, theft. They do file a police report. They do try to catch those people.
I'll take some of these calls to air if you guys have some stories in this regard that are useful. 800-800-7234. 800-800-RADIO. And yes, we're live. You can all see us on the video feed also at jcwshow.com. Click the, it's streaming live through a YouTube channel.
What about with the AI using the voices to sound like somebody as a relative?
Yeah, that's happened.
That's happened with the old folks.
Yep. They'll call up and say, I've got your daughter here, and they have a recording of her going, Daddy, please help me.
They did it to my parents. A guy called up and said, hey, this is William. This is my son. This is, you know, Mimi, this is William. I've been in an accident in St. Louis, and I'm in jail.
It was his voice?
It sounded like him.
Jeez.
Because he believed it was him. And I need you to send some money for my attorney. And like, they were about to do it. Dad went to pull the money and came back to the house. And just then, she'd been trying to call my son for hours.
Right.
Because she thought something was up, and my son finally called back, and they were on the phone with this guy who said he was the attorney that they were going to wire the money to. And William called and said, hey, what's going on? You've been calling me all day. I've been in the field. He's in the Marine Corps, you know?
Sure.
So, and they nearly got him for a few thousand.
And give me the VIN, dude. I mean, the cybercrime stuff is really, we have caught, last month, I think we caught $500,000 worth of fake stolen cars trying to come through the system at givemethevin.com.
$1 million?
$500,000 in a month.
Yeah.
Holy.
And we're having meetings with it, with title specialists, and here's what you look for, and here's what you pull, and then the different services. We pay thousands of dollars monthly and annually, tens of thousands annually, for these services to do backlog checks on these VIN numbers. Sure. And in the title work. It's bad, JD. It's so bad. Mike, have you seen any that you just couldn't catch?
There was no way. Now that we have certain policies, after we got burned, we were figuring it out. But it's so exhausting. I mean, it's exhausting because they're constantly changing.
We finally got the FBI involved. They're helping us.
Yeah, like they're now where they're. It's like the vehicle's in repo status, and somehow they're getting a title that they can sell the vehicle, but the car's still in repo status, and so how, there's
needs showing no payoff.
Yeah, no
showing
payoff
no payoff. Huh.
So how the hell did it get the title? It's so inside these DMVs. That's what it's coming down to,
right.
Really. And I don't know how the hell they can't catch them.
There's no question in Georgia that there's a problem. The FBI guy told us there's a problem inside
they're
Georgia.
Not really taking any time to actually investigate it.
Well, they started with us. We got that special crimes unit guy at the office now, and because we've stung two people. We set him up, and we popped him, and we arrested him.
Inside the DMV?
Yes.
Yes.
God, that's scary.
Yes. Oh, yeah. They're producing titles. Real government titles. Inside crooks, like inside prison stuff.
Sure.
And so, this is just ramped up in the last year?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
It's been coming for 5 years, but it's really been
getting ramped.
Yeah. And the problem is we buy one of them, and they get away with it, and then they start hitting us left and right.
Sure.
So I finally hired a guy, an ex-FBI guy, and then he still has connections at the FBI, and we've stung two of them recently, and hopefully the word spreads on that, that we're not suckers. But, I mean, if that happens to us, give me the VIN, how much happens to Carvana and CarMax?
I know that a CarMax won't basically buy a vehicle if the title's within 30 days. That's something that they've been... we've had people come say, well, CarMax won't sell buy my vehicle because the title's brand new. It's been within 30 days.
And that is a key tell.
Correct.
If it's a fresh print, no, not fresh prints, that we've got to watch it. Michigan's bad, too. But, I mean, when it shows a free lien, right, and the 30 grand lien's paid off, and then we give the guy the money, and the bank calls say, hey, there's a lien on this. I'm like, why didn't you report it? Well, we did. Well, then had to get the title. Well, we have the title. But they had a friend inside the DMV print him a title.
Wow.
That showed no lien. So it's a problem. Keith in Sacramento, good morning.
Hey, good morning. I was calling with some... Hello?
No, go ahead.
Oh, I was calling with some feedback. I'm a cybersecurity professional in the state of California. I work for government, and I help architect solutions to keep our users safe. But your advice to your audience regarding taking the domain mm-hmm. and then going to that website is decent advice, but there's better. Sometimes when you just go to these domains,
they're fake
they
too.
Have malware on them. And just by browsing to them, you can get a user's computer infected. So I tend not to advise people to follow the link.
Okay.
If it's suspicious, you know, go with your gut. Use a service like urlscan.io, which is a website you can post that domain into, and it'll tell you the reputation. It'll say this is good or this is bad. And that's a lot more safe than going to the potential hacker's website.
urlscan.io?
Correct. Right. Yeah, it's a really great site, but checks all of the different sources and actually scans and gives you a preview of that website without you actually going there. It's a good service, and it's free.
Anything else?
No, that was just it. It's always good to hear good tips going out to people because cybersecurity is a passion of mine, and, we work just to keep our corporate and personal environments safe and running. It's hard enough keeping Windows running with updates coming at you all the time, but... That's it.
Sure. Thank you, sir. John in Denver, Colorado. Good morning. You're on the air. No, it's, D. John.
Hey, John. Can you hear me?
Yes, loud and clear.
Okay. So I've been in law enforcement for 33 years, and I just want to tell you about the credit card fraud and the debit fraud. There's no insurance. Rarely gets investigated. They just charge you higher fees each and every transaction you use, each and every credit fee. That's just... It's just cost of doing business with them, and it's billions and trillions of dollars.
It is wild. Huh. Hang on. Chance in Colorado. Good morning. You're on the air. Chance, Colorado. Good morning. You're on the air.
Hey, I was more... I know y'all have changed subjects a couple times, but when y'all were talking about a credit card fraud, I believe it was, and, stolen funds, I guess, through the avenue of credit cards.
Yep.
I had an interesting, I guess, tidbit of information to share.
I've got 30 seconds.
About a guy a couple years back. His name's Matthew Cox. He was doing a mortgage fraud. He would make fake IDs and fake socials and then doctor these mortgage documents and basically mark up houses for huge amounts and then cash out on them. He would resell them, and then he would either resell them or take out loans on them. And he made upwards of it was somewhere from $6 to $10 million. But all the people's identities that he used, it was up to them to take the correct avenues, I guess you could say, to get their...
Sorry, Chance, I'm out of time. We're going to lose some cities right now on the switch, so jump over to the stream if we lose you in this time zone switch, jcwshow.com. The podcast goes up today at 2 o'clock. This show is brought to you by Give Me The VIN, V-I-N, VIN number, givemethevin.com, America's best car buyer. Give Me The VIN doesn't beat a written CarMax offer. Send you a check for $100, and we'll be back in some cities and not in other, but we'll be right on the stream at jcwshow.com.
The John Clay Wolf Show is heard every week on great stations like WBIG-FM, Big 100, Washington's Classic Rock, and WBCG in Port Charlotte, Big 98.9, Charlotte Harbor's Classic Rock. Stream us live online or pick up the country's fastest growing podcast at jcwshow.com and at johnclaywolf.com. And we'll be back with more of the John Clay Wolf Show right after this.
It off. Good morning, good morning, good morning. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Am I on mic? All right. Does it sound any better? Is it normal or is it?
It's not as muffled, but it just needs a little more bass on that one.
Well,
so.
That's me. Yeah. Okay. You want to do it?
Hey, we're going to shut her off on the last hour.
Yep. Okay. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. More bass, less bass. Baby got bass.